now it's all just like
we're just smoking weed and talking.
All right.
I showed my dad.
You want me to go?
Whenever you're ready.
All
right. So you showed your dick?
I showed my dad.
Oh, Woody Two Shoes.
I showed my dad the intro.
Episode 8, Dan Hall, baby.
I showed and be beloved by another half of the country.
Yeah, and I get to jizz. Into DJ T's tight ass.
That's how we start the podcast. Let's go.
You started off this episode by going, I'm not old.
Repping for the zombie apocalypse and we're prioritizing
PlayStation
first.
PlayStation. This is where we're going to die first.
Did I just get the golden fucking touch?
And then I have to explain to you websites.
You
That's
did.
What the Texas butthole tickler used to say when he ran away.
Trunch bowl. All
right, good pull.
Surely, was she...
What the fuck did you do?
Everybody sucks.
Dicks. And Rich is fucking full blown making out with this lady.
Quality content.
Hey. That's our guest producer for the day,
right.
Mason Smith.
Oh shit.
Who's also was the guest on episode 4. But my buddy Andy / producer Andy had to go do something. I don't know what. Didn't ask.
Andy.
He goes, he texts me. Oh, I've been putting, this brings up a good point.
Yeah.
I've been putting people in my phone. I've been changing their contacts to famous people's names.
That's not confusing.
What do you mean? Because as long as I know.
Let me, before I judge.
I should do it for Mason real quick and then I'll have
what
Mason.
What would Mason's be?
Oh, I already know what his is.
What is it?
Sturgill Simpson.
Oh, shit. That's so weird. For some reason, I wanted to say Thatcher. Like, where does Thatcher live? Are we on Thatcher Street? And I said Thurston. That's not Sturgis. Yeah. I thought that was the same word. Never mind.
There is
Sturgill Simpson's perfect for him.
Yeah, there is a Thatcher Street.
That's
right
what
there.
It threw me off, and then I was thirsty. It was a whole thing.
And then there's a Thatcher Shore Road right over there as well.
There's a Thatcher right
which
there.
Which I'm named after.
No shit.
I have roots.
It's a sick name.
Thanks.
It's a good name.
Yeah, people are like
Thatcher Wood.
People are like, you sound like you're an actor.
Yeah, it sounds like an author.
And I'm
name.
Like, oh, that's weird because I wanted to be.
Yeah. What's your middle name?
Taylor. And then I have two last names.
Thatcher.
Technically,
Thatcher T. Wood. Oh my
Thatcher
God,
T.
I'd read
Wood.
That book.
Fuck yeah.
Oh my God. That, be like romance and fucking.
It's coming another 20 years. That. The autobiography.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, once I gotta break. I gotta get the big break first.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Who's
I still have my phone. For it. So basically, I like Andy, producer Andy, is Larry Bird. So anytime he texts me or calls me, it comes up as Larry Bird.
Does he look like Larry Bird?
No, but he's just Larry Bird's like his favorite basketball player.
Okay,
it's kind of almost like what famous person would I associate with my friend.
Okay, what would I get? Don't say Jim Gaffigan.
Oh, I don't know yet, because I don't know you well enough.
Jim Gaffigan?
I don't know. That's a good one. Let me think about it.
What's the cook's name? What's the chef name that yells at everybody, the British guy?
Gordon Ramsay?
Gordon Ramsay. I've gotten...
It's not just who you look like.
I know. That's all I go off of.
Yeah. Like, my buddy Josh is Pakistani, but he's in there as Tom Brady.
Oh, I thought you were saying he's in there as Pakistani.
Pakistani Josh. Shout
Pakistani
out to my boy
Josh.
No, it's just like the most famous people that you can think of. Because, for instance, Josh's brother.
Yeah.
When I was telling him about this, because at first I was like, I'm going to let everybody name themselves.
Okay.
You know? And then
you can't let them do that. They'll pick cool names.
Well, he said Brad Marchand.
Yeah.
And I was like, all right, that's cool, but one out of five people are going to know.
Right. I like sort of know that name.
Yeah,
and I've heard it. Is he a football player?
He's been on the Bruins for the last five years.
I was in sports.
Boston sports. we're in the realm.
Is a ball or a puck.
But
or
then
something?
I was like, nobody knows who that is. So then I was telling someone else, my brother maybe, about it, and he's like, you can't let them name themselves.
Yeah.
And Queen Elizabeth had been brought up, like one person's going to be Queen Elizabeth, or whatever, just because, you know, be like, hey, I know the Queen, and,
right, for sure.
And then he was saying, well, he should be Queen Elizabeth. That's what he gets for trying to name himself.
Yeah, if you let people pick, you're going to have 40 Leonardo DiCaprios in your phone.
Yeah.
It's just, you can't have that.
Yeah. Everyone will be Tom. All the guys will be Tom Hardy.
Yeah.
You know, Tom Hardys. Yeah, yeah. And fucking Giselles.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, exactly. So you don't get to name yourself, people. So far, my dad's Howard Stern.
That's good.
Because he listens to Howard Stern religiously.
I don't know why that makes sense. Like, I get why they make sense when you say them. I don't know your father. We haven't seen each other in a while, but
he says hi, by the way.
Yeah.
He was like, when you see Dan,
because
I told him you're doing the podcast. He's like, when you see Dan, tell him.
I thought he was going to be here. I thought he'd be here.
Well,
but, you
COVID
know,
precautions.
Right. Of
family.
Course.
He's 67.
Course.
At this
you
want
to be safe. Yeah. Mr. Thatcher Wood.
Mr. Wood.
What the fuck were we talking about? I'm sorry. Oh, names.
Famous names.
Howard Stern. Yeah, yeah, yeah. The dad one. Give me another one that makes sense.
Josh is Tom Brady. Josh, just because, I mean, I've watched every Super Bowl essentially with him.
Okay. Tom Brady's in the No, it's not the Super Bowl today.
I haven't renamed my brother yet. It's going to be, I was maybe a famous musician, drummer, something.
Name him
like
Matt
that.
LeBlanc.
Matt LeBlanc.
Is that the guy's name? Joey from Friends?
Yeah.
Just really insult him.
Give him something that, who does he hate?
Yeah, yeah.
What character does he absolutely despise?
Mm.
That's a good idea. I like that. You're smoking your joint. I'm going to smoke my joint.
Yeah, am I too early?
Wait a second. This is a new addition to anybody who's been paying attention to the podcast. You know the studio's changed. Like, this is episode, what was that on the clapper? Eight? We're on eight?
Episode eight.
My producer's on the ball. He was like, eight. Hold on.
Looks like a boob.
Listen, you did your job. If we need anything Googled, you're there. Episode eight. This is probably the third different podcast setup I've had in eight episodes.
Yeah, you're just like,
but this
off.
One feels like it's going to be the most permanent.
This one's
for the foreseeable future.
I love this one.
Yeah, I like the chill. Like, you get the couch, I get my comfy chair.
Yeah.
If there's a second guest, they get a comfy couch.
Yeah, yeah.
So I did it with Mason. I had the chair he's sitting in. I had two of those. And it just, I felt
who's
like,
ever producing gets the massage chair.
Yeah. The producer, yeah.
Can
producer
I produce?
Gets a massage chair. But I just felt like rigid. Like, ugh, I'm just like stuck in my interviewer's chair.
Yeah.
I want it to be more of a hang, so.
Yeah, I just had to move because it's like, if you get too comfortable during a pod, you start to get like cozy and you're like not as quick. But then if you're too up, you feel like you're in like class or something.
You got to be on your game.
Yeah.
Sam Bucks has another level that he goes to on podcasts. We were talking about it. It's funny.
What does he do?
That was I bust his balls about
intriguing.
It. Because the episode that he did, he goes, wait, are we recording? Because he started telling a story and he goes, wait, are we recording?
Yeah.
And then he went back into the story. So I always bust his balls about how he turned. I mean, he's still Sam Bucks.
I like
that. That's a joke. It's kind of an inside joke.
I'm going to be honest. When we started, I was like, is this it? Is it happening now?
No, it's there.
But
is.
Also, he clapped the thing.
He clapped the thing. But like I said, this could we necessarily may not have even started.
Cool.
I could
like
decide
that.
That the last 10 minutes that we had was dog shit.
Yeah.
And then we could just start right now.
I love that earlier.
And
I
then
was like,
all
do
they
you
would
edit? I do pods like you don't edit, so I'll be fine.
And then
it's like, let's start now. We'll start it now.
But for all they know, we could have just started when I said start right now.
I know. It's insane, like, just learning editing this year. Like, you can make anyone say whatever you want.
How long have you been editing for?
You said video only a year, like maybe a year and a half. And then I've been a musician my entire life, so I've been around audio. I used to work for like corporate audio,
really?
Which is boring, but I've just been, you know, super interesting shit. But yeah, the quarantine helped. That was a good time.
And so did you just basically teaching? So you didn't go to school for any of that shit? You just been teaching yourself while you're doing your fun Facebook videos?
Yeah, my buddy's been my best friend since like high school has been in like video and broadcasting forever, and he used to edit all the our like sketch group, the South Shore Boys End podcast. Check it out.
You had a sketch group?
It's not. I don't know why I call it a sketch group. We do sketches, but we're not like a fucking. You know, we're not named like our couch pulls out, but I do. You know, it's not.
Who's in the South Shore Boys?
It's Logan O'Brien, Tyler Swain, and me. I don't know why I thought I was saying another name. But my buddy Kev edited all that shit, and I would just always be behind him watching him. So at one point, it was like, I'm going to have to learn how to do this on my own. So this was kind of the time I learned to do it. I did it on my phone, and then now I'm all the way over to like the Adobe suite and all that shit, because it seems like everyone uses that.
That's kind of how I was.
Yeah, yeah. It's like, well, everyone's speaking in Adobe, so.
I don't edit that much because I have no patience. That's why you edited the intro instead of me.
Yeah, I don't know where I got like the patience, because I don't have patience for fucking anything. But it's like when I do a video for myself, I am like, I want to get it done as quick as possible. So I have to like learn something, yep. And it might take me like when I learned how to green screen shit, it was like a 3-day process for one video. And then now it's like, you know, it's like an afternoon.
I'm a little bitch because if I could just get through the learning process of that.
It's just
the editing part's fun. I enjoy that. But it's when I get to a troubleshooting thing and then I'm in like mid editing.
Yeah.
And then I got to go to the video, to YouTube, yeah, to be like, how do I put this overlay in?
That was always my thing. It was like, if you just commit to like a 17-minute video of a guy being like, here's what you're going to do.
Yeah, taking notes and shit.
Yeah, yeah. It does suck, but that's the hurdle. Like, once you start doing anything or video or podcast, like all this shit, you know what I mean? It's like people who are like, hey, we should do this, or you should do this, or I want to do this. The theory people don't understand, like, it's not necessarily easy, but, like, once you get it going, you just want to make it better and better and better and better and better. You know what I mean? So, like, you've gotten it to this point. Even today, you were changing shit. All right, like, in, like, you know, adding the monitor and everything.
Yes.
And, like,
the whole thing? Sorry, I'm listening. Oh, totally. But I'm
fine.
Also trying to
like,
get a cookie.
I want to see what's getting cut. Oh, the cookies, baby.
I was just hoping you would. All right, fine.
Oh,
I was hoping he was going to, I was like thinking he might just throw me one cookie.
That was a Brandon Marchand catch right there.
Yeah.
Your buddy.
Yeah. Home run.
Yep. That was a home run. I played sports. I can't watch them. I just don't know people's names.
Really?
Yeah.
These two are stuck together.
That's okay. That's one. That's like a mighty.
I'm just going to have to eat both of them.
It's like when you get a 10-piece nugget.
Mason, do you want this last one?
No, no.
Yeah, Dan, eat it.
All right, I'll eat it.
Mason's wife made these cookies, and Mason's been basically pushing them on us like a fucking drug dealer.
You can't see it off camera, but Mason's holding a gun to both of us until we eat.
Also, if you guys wouldn't have took them, I had three before.
Yeah,
I just
threw
those
over there.
Dude,
I was watching you chow down. I'm like, I got to eat one or two of these before he eats them all. Yeah. This poor guy's going to have a fucking goddamn sugar overdose.
Going to a diabetes coma.
See, then I stop talking.
So anyway, editing.
I just want to know about the cookie.
Editing. Editing is a motherfucker.
I don't know. Do people care about it? I could talk about editing all day, and I'm like, oh, this is so boring.
The beauty of this is I don't give a fuck what people care about.
Yeah.
It's all about how I talk. It's like how I navigate a conversation or hang out with people that I know or don't know.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. So there is editing's so cool. You guys have no idea.
Oh my god.
You don't even know. Oh my god, dude.
I'm putting the cookie down.
Dude, bro. You don't.
Oh my god.
No, you don't even know, dude.
The Adobe suite is so sweet.
It's so fucking
sweet. I love Premiere and Illustrator.
All right. So you're basically learning on the fly, similar to how I'm doing it, but you're going at a faster pace.
Yeah, the only thing is, you're fucking dealing with a whole production and 2 hours of footage and everything. It's like I'm doing a 1-minute video on my phone. It's a little easier to just pump out. And
yeah, but I feel like you're helping make excuses for me here, because I really I gotta
get your shit together, Thatcher.
All I really have to do is just match up the audio and the video, and then maybe occasionally throw in like a picture overlaid in it. You know,
you're like, oh, a picture. Yeah. God.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I know. I still get mad at editing. It's like my computer, like, I'm all this shit with podcasting and whatever, I'm learning it as well with the OBS and all the streaming stuff. It's like, I don't know if my computer, at a certain point, you're like, okay, why isn't this working? Is it that I have a computer that's like a year too old or something? Like, yep. I tried to set up OBS on a MacBook Air, like whatever generation it was. And I looked it up and it was like, OBS does not work specifically with this one Mac.
Yeah.
And I was like, cool, 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 Apple.
I bought that fucking, that thing recently.
Yeah.
I'm still paying it off on my Best Buy card.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is great for podcasting,
yeah,
but is not the best thing to use with Adobe. Like, Adobe works way better with PC from what I've heard. Because okay, I'll still have weird latency issues, like just like tiny little lag,
sure, yeah,
like playback issues when I just start playing a video.
Yeah, Mac
it'll
like
take a weird second, and I'm just like,
what is native to them? Is it Final Cut or like whatever that has become? Like what works?
But maybe or they just want you use or they just want you to use iMovie.
iMovie sucks. It's like fucking.
Shout out, by the way, this podcast is sponsored by iMovie. But anyway, continue.
Shout out iMovie. What the fuck? I forgot what I was saying.
iMovie sucks.
iMovie sucks.
Yeah, why
dude?
Does Apple
it's
make us?
It's literally a PowerPoint with like, I don't know.
Because Steve Jobs was like, I want it to be a closed system. No, nobody else gets in. And we only have our own chargers and blah, blah. And
yeah,
then Apple took that like to the fucking moon.
Fuck Apple
beyond.
Too. I just got the new iPhone.
Fuck
and
Apple.
Fuck
I just
Apple,
bought
dude.
Like seven of your products, by
yeah,
the way.
I will be loyal to you forever because I can't. I don't feel comfortable. I get anxious when I hold a Samsung.
Exactly.
My buddy bought a Samsung one day and then returned it the next day. He was like, I can't do it. I just can't. It was like the one. It was the Samsung, or not even Samsung. It was an Android that turned. I don't know. I'm holding it like a fucking kroner.
It's okay. Is that how you do stand up? Do you always have to do
it? Yeah, I always hold it. I'm like, boo, boo, boo.
You don't pull the mic out of the stand. You do the.
I haven't. Yeah,
do the lean.
I'll just say that since Corona, like my
like
last.
Steven Tyler?
Yeah, the last, like. Yeah, I have a. I bring my rag up. What the fuck? Bandana? Scarf.
Your rag? Yeah.
Yeah, it's knitted scarves. The last, like, five shows, the week before everything shut down in March. All my shows, I didn't touch the mic, and like normally I have it, and I used to do a bit. I was saying this to someone just in terms of COVID.
You get your hands
times.
Behind your back. You're like, ladies and gentlemen.
No, I was like, I think I actually am better this way because
yeah.
I talk. I'm not fucking Italian, but I'm
you
dumb.
Gestate
so
a lot
I,
with
you
your
know,
hands.
I don't do well with words, as you could probably tell. But
gestate. So I said gestate. By the way, I said gestate with
gestate.
Your hands.
I just
gesture.
Dated this morning.
You just, yeah.
And I'm doing dad jokes over here.
Words,
kill myself.
I have trouble with words. Guys.
I got to draw what I'm fucking saying to you with my hands.
Yeah.
Gestate.
exactly.
I'm off the hinges
yeah.
here.
Yeah. No, that's how this is supposed to go. It's great, dude. We're killing it.
I'm jumping to things. It's like, go there, go there. Yep. Gestate. Let's go backwards. Where were we? Gestate.
Oh, we were talking about not touching the mic.
Yeah.
I'm doing, by the way,
great
I'm
going
to tap myself on the back for remembering shit today.
I am horrendous at podcasting for the reason of like.
Short-term memory.
You'll see in this episode. I've already done it like three times where I go, I don't know what the fuck we're talking about. What were we saying?
Yeah, that's
like,
cool.
Like the second after I stopped talking about the thing we were just talking
Does
about.
Does that drive you nuts when you're watching a podcast and they're like, what the fuck were we talking about? And the goddamn, they don't remember. The producer can't remember.
Yeah.
It's like anybody
and you
not
do?
Paying attention.
You're
yeah.
screaming in your car.
yeah, and you're like, fucking, you were talking about just dating with your hands.
Yeah, it's like, this was recorded a month and a half ago and it's been banged, but I'm going to DM you.
Yeah.
Hey, it was roses or something.
Yeah, exactly.
I used to do a bit when I started comedy where I'd take the mic, you know, I always held the mic and I would be like, oh, it was some dumb bit where it was like, oh, here's a, you should never, what was the fucking bit? You should never put chapstick on when you're high in traffic because it looks like this. And then I'd take the mic and a lot of, the first couple times I did this bit, I would like put the mic on my face and it was a loud enough system that it would pick up like the yeah. of me rubbing a fucking microphone on my face. Disgusting. Like literally on my lip. It was the grossest thing ever. And then the day I stopped doing this bit, I was on a show where it was like a very quiet, like backroom show and they had a PA, but it was like very low. And I like did the punchline and then I put the mic up to my lip and it like didn't make a noise. So I was like, it didn't get the effect. And I like pulled it back and did it again. And I was like, ah, oh, fuck. And the bit was just over. I slammed myself in the face with a
you
mic.
Like chipped your tooth.
How many times I've hit my fucking mouth on a goddamn mic and then I'm like, forget it, I hate it, yeah, I hate everything. Like,
good night, ladies and
gentlemen. Oh my god, I'm not dinner. Yeah, baby. Yeah, I don't know.
So you don't touch mics anymore.
We don't touch mics anymore.
So the long and short of it,
I come out is, like Ed Sullivan. I put my hands behind my back and I'm like, folks,
ladies and gentlemen,
ladies and gentlemen.
Boys and girls, children of all ages.
Yeah, fuck iMovie. And what else?
Android, your buddy's Android. You touched it.
Oh, yeah. He got, so it was a PlayStation controller. That was like the fucking like sell on it. It was an Android and it was like, but it can also be used as a PS3 controller. And my buddy was
with
like,
your, with your
give
PS3?
It to me. What?
As opposed to just buying a PS3 controller, you're like,
I guess
I need,
so. I don't
need,
know.
I need my PlayStation controller to answer calls too.
Yeah, yeah. It's like I don't fucking know what the sell was. It's funny to think like it's just, oh, I need a remote, so I'm gonna download a remote app, and that's just a thing now. And it's like, imagine doing that. And then the next day, he was like, I need to go back to Apple, because Apple, they brainwash you. They just give it to you in these giant compartments. And like anytime I hold an Android, I have a panic attack. I'm like, where are the apps?
I actually had a Galaxy to start. That was like the first smartphone I had. And I thought it was like very user friendly. And I liked it a lot. And I went to Apple and there was it was funny. It was the stupidest little thing. But on the Apple phones, like, if I set an alarm and I want to snooze it,
yeah,
the snooze is always 9 minutes. So 100%. If I, otherwise I got to set 100 different alarms.
That's how I always
but
do
on
it.
An Android, if you want to snooze for a half an hour, you could hit snooze and it's like, hey, how long do you want to snooze for?
Ooh.
And you're like, I don't know, 25 minutes.
Don't trust me right
34
now.
34 minutes. You know what I mean? But it's like that stupid little feature. I was like, this fucking Apple phone sucks, dude.
Yeah.
I can't even set a fucking snooze. But I just had that one broke. And I was like, you know what? I'll get another. Maybe I'll. And then now I'm like,
now you're just in it. And you're like, fuck,
I
got stuff in the cloud. I can't leave.
I don't have stuff in the cloud. Or at least I hope I don't.
I don't know if I do. I think I do.
Yeah, that's my
point, always like,
dude.
It's full. And I'm like, I haven't put anything in it.
I didn't even fucking put
anything
in.
I didn't do anything. It's like, buy more. I'm like, what did I do?
Yeah, dude. I didn't even. What did I put in there? I didn't physically. I don't remember saying, "Hey, throw that in the cloud for me."
Yeah.
I don't remember that moment, but it's like, by the way, your cloud storage is getting pretty.
I bought the 99-cent thing. I was like, I need it. Is that door? Did I?
I don't know.
Not shut it.
I don't know.
Did you
Sorry.
Feel a breeze?
Yeah.
I think I felt a breeze.
Did you feel it?
Was that a ghost that just passed through us?
Listen, it's a little drafty.
Oh, that's fine. I'm
that
all about it.
That door still needs to be trimmed.
I'm just
but
making
it's not
sure
really...
I'm not having a stroke.
No, this room has never really been properly heated. It's still fairly new. It's probably only like 7 or 8 years old. As far as like being redone and refinished.
Yeah, those are good rafters. You can put some kayaks up there or something.
No.
You can store some kayaks up there.
You could store some shit, but it would look shitty.
It would look bad.
I like it the way it is. For now, it's a podcast studio.
I got some kayaks I'll bring over. I need to store them.
Till Woody Two Shoes generates some income and I can build my own studio, this is going to be it.
Dude, this is like...
Until I move somewhere. But I mean, this could always... I mean, why not? Maybe I could just move and always keep this as the studio.
100%.
Yeah.
You should move into a studio and just keep this as the studio.
Move
you
into
live
a
in the
studio
yeah.
and then build like that into an apartment and then keep this.
Get yourself a hot plate. You're good to go. You got a hot plate? Oh, you just cook on the fucking heater.
I make breakfast. No, I got a hot plate, dude. I got a.
I thought you were pointing to the space heater. I was like, that's cool.
The fucking radiator.
Make eggs on the. Yeah.
Yeah. You just put a plate on that won't crack. It gets really, really hot.
Something would work there, I think.
Could you cook eggs?
I don't think it gets hot enough.
Could you get a plate hot enough sitting on a hot plate that you could just cook the eggs right on that plate? Or would the plate probably break? Depending.
It's got to be.
If it was ceramic
tempered.
Tempered.
I don't know. I had to buy.
This is the podcast of stupid questions. I ask so many fucking wonderfully dumb questions this thing. It's great.
I always like a video that I got like in the summer. There's always videos that come up of like a guy trying to cook an egg. On the street.
Yep.
And I always want to do that, and it's not that hard. You just get an egg and go outside. But it's like, I'm nervous of my neighbors always seeing me doing a video. and just like having to run into them later and be like, yeah, you're trying to cook an egg out on the sidewalk there, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, like if I'm doing like a live feed, I've been trying to do like lives on like TikTok or Instagram and shit.
I want
to
do this live, but it's insecurities.
It's worse than doing stand up.
It's like, it's hard. It's not cool being insecure. All right.
It's
just
wild being insecure.
It's wild, but like we're all insecure.
Oh, 100%.
And then like stand up, acting. We had this conversation. I say this all the time. I have this conversation with people all the time about acting and the insecurities and like learn. I mean, I don't know shit about acting, but the few things I learned about it was you have to be yourself, and being yourself is like really vulnerable because all your insecurities are out there. And so that's why we all put up these fucking facades and like these blah, blah, blah. I probably said this 100 times in the last.
No, I get it. I'm on board.
But like, I get why it's like you feel weird about cooking an egg in front of your neighbors, but you're like, this is what, I don't know if you know this, but I do. This is what I do.
I know. Yeah.
I make videos.
It's so funny. Cause we just moved right in September, to this new house, and like it got cold quick. Like, so we didn't really meet the neighbors, like, in the warm weather, like, a lot of hay.
Oh, everybody's out in the backyard.
Yeah, there wasn't too many of those. So, these people must just think I'm, like a stock trader. I'm up, like, all hours of the night, because I've been unemployed for, like, 300 days now.
Oh, Jesus.
So, like, they must
forget that.
I'm just, like, sitting on the back porch drilling butts like a Japanese guy and fucking squatting on the back.
Yeah.
And, like... I can see the Boston skyline through, it's like, I have to look through backyards, but I feel like when I'm sitting there smoking on my deck and I'm looking at the Boston skyline over the ocean, I'm also it looks like I'm looking into their kitchen window and there's always someone there and they always catch me and I'm like, I'm not looking at you, but I will act as if like, I'll turn away like, oh, I wasn't looking at you and that makes it worse.
Yeah.
So when I meet them in, you know, May or April, I'm going to be like, hey, I'm not fucking weird. I'm not a serial killer.
No, I just, listen, that, I don't know if you know, but the skyline's like.
Guys, if we, I'm literally, like, I have
you want to come over? Just kind of come upstairs.
I literally have the problem of, like, how do I get my neighbor to cut down his tree in his backyard? I'm going to sneak over there one night. If he wakes up and it's gone.
That's a thing around here where people.
Is it really?
Yeah, but it's, like, bad.
Yeah, it seems like a old West crime.
People have bullshit. They run into bullshit with the building department about building too many stories up because it'll restrict someone's view of
right,
the ocean.
Right, right. Yeah,
type of thing. It's so fucking ridiculous.
Yeah, so me and Mason live on like Cape Cod Light or like Diet Cape Cod. It's housed.
Yeah.
Neck. It's like
you've been out there.
Yeah, yeah. You've driven by my house.
Exactly, Diet Cape Cod. There's actually one part where there's those barriers right near the water.
Yeah, yeah.
There's the beach right there, and it looks exactly like a spot right over here.
Yeah.
By Chapin Beach.
That's like right where my house is at, that split. Like,
no shit.
And it's, I feel like we live in a boat.
It's a cool spot.
It's a very nautical home.
It's got a cool view, too.
Yeah. If my neighbor cut down his fucking tree, it'd be a better one.
But, it's bullshit. Perfect example. I got shut down at a job last week because the neighbor called the building department and said, I don't know if they have a permit, like they might be working without a permit.
Who the fuck has the time to do that?
And then so the building inspector shows up and he's just like, I'm not gonna shut you down, but just so you know, like, I'm here because someone one of the neighbors complained. And the poor lady, she's all distraught because it's the fucking, probably that, she's like, it's that guy, it's the same guy, he's always giving us problems.
It's this bitch over here.
Why?
Been unemployed for 300 days making Facebook videos.
He's a lawyer, so she was afraid to have us, even though the building inspector was like, I'm not going to shut you down, you can keep working, just get the express permit, make sure you put in for it. And she did, but she was so nervous about,
we do contracting,
the douchebag that because he's a lawyer, that I had to like, we got to hold off. I'm probably going back Tuesday. I do like construction. Just
okay,
I have a small little
gotcha.
Operation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I just built this deck right here.
Nice.
Up.
This is all you. Nice.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah, just small little stuff. It's just me and my brother.
I went to a fucking trade high school. Quincy High had like fucking plumbing, electrical, welding, carpentry, all that shit.
Yeah.
And I was in fucking choir, Thatcher. I could have been making a good amount of money and have a bunch of tattoos. That's what they seem to do.
Was it a vocational high school? Like, was it
a
technical school?
The Quincy Vo-Tech. There was Quincy High Vocational High School.
Yeah.
And
so what, you were in the choir?
I was in choir, band, art, and theater.
And those are considered part of a vocational school?
That's what I mean. It's like the options I had.
How is that even allowed?
I could have had my own van with a ladder tied to the top.
Dude, I'm trying to think if Cape Tech has a fucking band. They must have a band for the football team.
We were like a high school, and then also they were like, and we know you're all pieces of shit.
But I don't understand how you could have solely those. Like, there's not any other thing they made, a class they made you take.
Like, oh, yeah, no. It was like English, and the other one's math and stuff. Like, we do that, and then there was... Yeah.
Yeah. Well, but that's how the tech is. They still take math and English, but they also do, the, like you said, plumbing,
yeah,
et cetera, et cetera. So I don't understand. Like, so your other, you took, so.
I picked the worst ones, I'm trying to say. The investment of my creativity was more important to me.
Those almost seem like extracurricular activities.
Yeah. That's what you do when you ate.
Like an actual course that's part of your vocational.
Right. I could have learned how to measure stuff. I could have learned how to read a tape measure. Now I'm sitting there, I'm like,
you still could.
8/16 is a half, I think, right?
Yeah. The best is when someone was like, I need four eighths or like
right.
Six
they'll
eighths.
Say the
like, you they're like 6/8, you mean 3/4?
That's what I'm so nervous about.
Minuteman High School? Is that where you went to school?
Nah. Oh, I was a 10-minute man.
Huh?
We're looking up high schools.
It was Cape Cod. Isn't this a vocational thing? These Minutemen high schools? Is that not a thing?
Yeah, but these are like where criminals go.
Oh, okay.
Quincy High created criminals.
I thought that was one single place. There's a bunch of these.
The way I understood it, I thought Minutemen High School was like a. They're all over. Look, Arlington, Bolton, Concord, Dover. Lancaster, Lexington, Needham.
They're like Johnson and Wales, right?
Because when you said vocational school, because like we had a vocational school outside of our high school.
Yeah.
There was a separate thing that you could
get. That's exactly what, like you had a choice.
Right. Because I did Metal Fab.
I could either go to Dennis Yarmouth.
Metal Fab.
Or I could go to Mid-Cape Tech.
Did machine class.
Yeah, I guess it was
Lower Cape or whatever it was. Yeah. There's Upper Cape Tech and Lower Cape Tech.
Yeah, we had Quincy and North Quincy.
Yeah.
But they weren't a fucking tech school.
But I didn't know
they
had
just a bunch
like,
of readers over
I know
there.
They had choir. I didn't know there was a choir at the tech school.
Even looking at it from that perspective, I was like, yeah, I went to a normal high school. And then you look at it, it's like, no, you did choir at a tech high school.
I wish I went to one of those trades. I didn't go to a technical school. And I basically went to community college for a couple months, skipped all my classes because I was a douchebag.
Yep.
And pretty much went into construction right out of high school because my dad was in the trade, so like I got a job through that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Then like,
were you and Ann's son
siding
on a van?
No. He always worked for somebody. He never did.
Gotcha,
anything.
Gotcha.
Did you go to North or South or regular or North?
In terms of what?
High school.
Cape Cod. No. Oh, I went to just Quincy High. We didn't have to specify what part of the compass.
Are you trying
we were
to
on.
Find Dan's?
Yeah,
Quincy High School.
He was in a movie.
Oh, yeah. I was in Here Comes the Boom, and they shot at our old high school.
Really?
As the fucking...
You were... What scene were you in? Wait, Here
I
Comes
the
Boom is
in
the
high school band. The whole point of that movie is, like, the music department is getting shut down, or, like, there's not enough funding or whatever.
Yeah.
And Kevin James...
Goes into MMA.
Yeah, starts...
That was one of the first... Yeah, I went to that movie with my girlfriend my ex-girlfriend, early in our relationship, and we got like drunk on wine at the beach and then went to see this, like we were sipping wine and smoking weed or something, then went to see this movie and I had to leave because we were just shit-faced and she was giggling her head off.
I've never been in the movies drunk. That's like a
it
fun...
was.
I definitely
I couldn't even focus on the movie. I was like,
it's better than Zookeeper.
But it was
that's what I'll rate it.
It was decent. I remember the movie now, and you were in the band.
I was the guy that Henry Winkler in the beginning says, "Dan, drum roll, please," and it cuts to me, and I'm wearing a Scally cap.
What? I'm trying to find it.
It's very hard to find. I got cut out of the FX edit,
Okay. Which
is very funny to think that someone in an editing room. At FX.
Was just like, yeah, I don't like the guy with the Scully cap.
We got to fit a fucking Huggies commercial in. Let's get rid of the kid with the fucking Scully cap. See you later.
I was in That's My Boy.
Oh, no shit. Yeah, because all that, it's all Happy Madison because he loves being, or he's like from New Hampshire, right?
I think he's from New York.
Is he really?
Yeah. What? But they just film, I think at the time.
That's my boy's Adam Sandler, right?
That's my boy was Adam Sandler.
Yeah, yeah, okay. With Andy Samberg, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I've seen that.
Massachusetts was given big tech. They wanted to, remember, they wanted to do Hollywood North.
Plymouth, right?
Hollywood East or whatever it was in Plymouth. They were going to build like all these studios.
Yeah.
Because Massachusetts was given huge tax breaks.
Yeah, it's like there in New Orleans. Movies. Or like everyone was like, it's going to be like New Orleans.
So that's why a lot of movies were getting made in Massachusetts.
Yeah. Is that still, because they're doing
probably still a thing.
And they're starting or like they're in production. I don't know how the fuck they worded it, but it's some like crime drama that it's a true story. It's based off a book that Robert Downey Jr. is playing some killer in P-Town that murdered a bunch of dudes back in like the 70s. And they're going to start shooting that soon. And I'm like, let's fucking sneak on that set, Thatcher.
Yeah.
How do we get it to be extras?
Figure out when the casting is and we'll send our fucking headshots in.
Everything casting is like, pay us $30 a month. And I'm like, is this how they do it?
You get paid all right.
No, I just mean like the boss, like Boston Casting is always like sign up for an account or premium. And I'm like, I feel like that's like.
That's dated, dude. There's other ways. It feels there's that other way. Ways. You just got to grind and do it yourself.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
fucking
yeah.
Find the people and send your shit out. You can print your own headshots. You can find the mailing lists. You can, you know what I mean? Like there's ways to seek it out. You just got to do your due diligence.
I went in for one audition and like I was looking up how to do the headshot on the back of the resume thing. And I stapled the headshot to the resume and they also weren't the same size. It was just like, it made like an L, like one of them stapled kind of was a little bigger. And I just think that's why I didn't get it. I'm like, it was cause it was stapled. I didn't do the fucking double sided resume. It was like, this is a huge thing. Google was all about it. And I was like, fuck, I fucked it up.
When I did an acting workshop, I lived in New York for like 8 months and that was one of the things they were talking about, resumes, do's and don'ts. When you get an email, don't fucking put 100 different numbers
right
in the thing. Just do your name. Like, make it simple. Just
be punctual and quick.
Yeah, Dan Hall, Pat's fan, fucking 84. You know what I'm saying? Fuck that. You know, just Dan Hall at Gmail.
Yeah, I did one audition and I'm like, fuck, I want to do more.
It was acting's fun. I know.
I love
sitting
acting.
Around sucks, but acting's fun.
I
like
love
people
acting.
Like acting's. It's so boring. It's but I love acting.
It's so much fun.
You get to be so many different characters. That's what I loved. I grew up on movies. Like I'm a self-proclaimed movie buff. I fucking love movies.
Yeah,
and I wanted to be in them so bad. Like, I wanted to be an actor. So
yeah,
bad.
I think like I didn't. I think I wanted to, but didn't realize it until like comedy or whatever. But like. I went in on the audition. I started doing all these videos, basically in spite of that audition, to be like, next time I'm going to be ready.
Yeah.
Do pull-ups in the
I'll
cell.
Do it myself.
Yeah, you're literally
you
like,
guys, I'm
you
creating
could argue,
my own content.
You could argue every video you've seen for the past 9 months is in spite of not getting one audition.
There you go.
The first one I've ever been on. I was like, son of a bitch.
Yeah.
Anyway. I'm just bad at the clerical work. I can't do like, I'm bad at like being organized and like verbal speech clearly or whatever writing. Just, I can't even say what I'm trying to say.
Yeah. The clerical work. That's such a great
right?
way of putting
That's
it.
That's what it is.
That's what it is. The fucking responsibilities of the goddamn clerical work. That's like my downfall.
When it's like double-sided.
With everything.
Double-sided. I got the print to go on one side.
People watching this are like, you fucking pussies. Like, I, like, there's like people with kids or all
mean.
This
like,
shit. And I'm just like, dude, I don't know how you do it. I don't know how you do it. I don't know how you do it. Okay. I'm going to learn. It takes me forever. I'm always late to the party, but.
Yeah. I'm an auditory learner or whatever the fuck.
I'm a like visual.
Well, yeah.
Has
like,
to do it next
yes.
to you learner.
Yeah. Like show me it and I'll be able to do it. And like. Once I'm like a fucking AI robot. It's
you can't
like, once
explain
you teach
it
to
me
to
over
learn,
the phone.
I'll be able to learn it all.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's what it is. I'm a very slow AI robot because I'm like YouTube.
Yep.
Background, ambient music. Anyway.
Yeah. And the people that created you are like, It's in its infant stage. It's, you know, it learns. Think of it as like a child, okay? You know, it's a sponge, but it's still like a,
guys, I got the pinky on not the keyboard today.
Complete control of all its, you know, cognitive functions, all that, you know, its limbs and stuff. It's not fully coordinated.
Yeah, if every job interview instead of a resume, not even audition, just job interview, if I could have just gone in and been like, I'm sick at this, I guess that's what the interview is, but I'm like, I'm trying to remember what the fuck I faked on the resume that they're holding. And they're like, tell me about this. And I'm like, I can't. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, and that's the scene in like every buddy movie.
Yeah.
Where like the hotshot friends like just goes in and he's like, next thing you know, he's doing shots.
Yeah.
Like
the one
guy's like, listen, okay, my boss, he's like really fucking strict. Right. All right. He hates when you fucking look him in the eye. Yeah, blah, blah, blah. Right. And the guy goes in, sits down, looks him right in the eye. He's like, what's up, Dan?
Yeah.
He's like, let me tell you something, dude. I would fucking crush at this job.
Dude,
and
yeah.
And then cut scene to him doing shots with the boss later. And you're just like, why can't I be that guy in interviews?
Yeah, there's a guy.
Why doesn't the world work like that?
I just met like this real estate agent. His name's Marcus Walker Realty. Check him out.
Marcus Walker Realty. Yeah. Shout out.
I'm just intrigued by his sales and like the way he like approaches like just conversation. Because when he talks to you, he goes, what does he say? He goes, hey, nice to meet you. What's the best thing that's happened to you today? Like, it'll be like, hey, I'm Dan. Hi, I'm Thatcher.
Yeah.
Hi, Thatcher. What's the most? And like, he goes, it's a pattern switch. Because normally I'd be like, oh, great. How are you? Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
But it like breaks it. And I'm like, what the fuck? You like dog training humans without me noticing?
People who understand psychology way better than we do.
Yeah. And I don't get it. So I always think it's happening from like outside sources. So I'm always like fucking paranoid. I should probably stop smoking weed if I'm doing this a lot in my backyard alone.
I hate unsolicited, like people like coming up to me trying to like sell me shit. So then if I was in a sales position, for instance, worked a kiosk for a little bit with a buddy of mine trying to sell cell phones, like a Sprint fucking kiosk.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to like sell the plans and the
like,
phones. Like, you're like working on commission essentially. Like you're not making any money standing there.
Yeah. They're like, and we have to a like booth and a phone and a
essentially
sign.
Catcall everybody that walks by you. And I would just be so embarrassed to even say anything to any, like, I don't know. I feel like such an asshole. But you almost have to be a little shameless.
You really do. It feels
like shameless.
You're faking.
And be like,
I did the same thing. I worked as a, for 6 days, and then I called in sick one day, and then I never showed up again. I emailed. I go, sorry, I'm not coming in today. I'm sick. And then the next day I said, hey, I can't work here. I didn't say, I was like, I'm going to kill myself if I work there for the rest of my life.
Was it like a,
it was like a mom and pop, what do you call them? Appliance store. It's like fridges, fucking everything, TV, all that shit. And they've been around for like years and years.
That reminds me of, continue.
No. It's just like, so people, they were trying to teach me sales that for, I was doing like social media, but on the side, they were like, we're also going to teach you to be a salesman. And like, I sat in this front box little thing in front of like the floor of all the appliances and shit with these two other guys. And they were like, one day I was 1 minute late and the guy was like, we start work at 8. And I was like, well, I'm quitting this job at the end of the week.
Yeah.
But then on top of that, they'd be like, I've been here since I was your age. And I was like, holy
That's
shit.
That's a problem for
I'm
you.
I'm out of here, dude. I'm getting the fuck out. And here's the other thing with the sales thing. When they were teaching me, they'd be like, this is the price we can give it to them at. And it's like, if someone comes into me and they're like, well, can I get it any cheaper? I'm going to go, no. But you can go on Amazon or Lowe's. Like, I don't want to fuck someone over.
Yeah.
I would want someone to be like, no, just go to Amazon. Yeah. Don't use this.
Yeah.
Customer service, who cares about that?
Yeah.
Just call the Maytag, man.
Yeah.
So I was like, I'm out. I have the flu, and then I was like, see you later.
I was going to work at the Stop and Shop right down the street.
Yeah.
And they had me in training.
Yeah.
And it was like, I think they were half shifts, maybe 4-hour shifts or whatever, but the you literally are sitting there at a computer program.
Yeah.
It's teaching you how to bag groceries.
Yeah.
And I can't remember if I literally just like walked out mid, like I think I might have mid computer program just walked out.
I have that same thing. Walked
out of the fucking Stop and Shop. My shift might have been over. I might have been a little bitch and like probably finished the shift or whatever it was. But I don't even think I went back to collect the check.
I'm punching out 2 minutes early.
I didn't even collect the check though. I didn't even want to see the. I was like, no, I'm all set.
Oh yeah, that last week I was like, I'm done forever working here. I was like, send me the check at this address though. I worked at Stop and Shop too. I did bagging and then the last day I did groceries and I didn't walk off, but I was like, I have schoolwork and I'm not working there anymore. I can't stand in one spot for any amount of time.
Some of us are not built like that.
Oh
dude.
My God, I can't do it. Like,
you just are like, you're like, I can't. And look, no offense to anybody, like the guy who's like, I've been here since I was your age. Like, probably made a decent living. He's got kids. Like,
that's what you
want
to do.
He's got a nice place. Like, he's got security or whatever. But I just look at people like that and I'm like, just like, how? How do you end up being the true value guy for 37 fucking years?
And maybe, and then I start to get into my own ego and I'm like, well, am I a dick for being like,
Wanting something greater for yourself?
Not that. Being like, why would he hate that? Like, maybe that's his fucking.
Yeah, I guess.
Maybe not the true value guy, but like,
yeah, everyone's wired differently.
A good,
you know,
salesman job for your entire career, like maybe that's like, I'm sure that's dope to everybody. Like, that's over 60, you know. Civil service job, salesman, lawyer, nurse, doctor.
I'm just
overly,
overly curious all the time about everybody. Dude, any place I go, I'm like, what is this guy doing here? How did he end up here? And why this everywhere?
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm just always curious. I'm like, curious,
you're high
George.
In public a lot. I do the same. That's what it is.
All right. Fair enough.
I tell my girlfriend these things. She's like, I don't have these thoughts.
Yeah, I know. I see the time. Yeah, we're going to get to that. We had some good momentum, though. Way to just fucking put it.
Thanks, right Sturgill.
I'm just kidding, dude. God. I'm having fun. I was just going to get to that. Like,
I'm
right
super
up.
High, and I wasn't paying attention. And I just looked up, and we were at 45 minutes, and I was like, fuck, I was supposed to tell him at 30.
And you were just talking about being high in public, so that's fucking
That was good. Perfect. All right, guys, let's start over.
All right. Just hit stop, and then
start
recording again.
iMovie.
He's so confused. I'm just kidding. We're not,
don't touch anything.
No, we're not stopping the fucking podcast, dude. So the first segment, there's two segments.
Oh shit,
of this whole thing. Yeah, I do segments. One of them is been a running thing for the last three or four episodes. I did it with Sam Buck too. It's been pretty consistent. I think I forgot to do it with somebody once or I don't know. Anyway.
I'm excited to hear what it is.
The fucking point is the big reveal. While you're there, can you grab me one of those leggers?
Mason's at the fridge.
The back right. They're actually not that bad. Ed Waugh left them in the fridge. Shout out to Ed Waugh, Cape Cod comedian.
Ed Waugh, yeah. I'm not driving. Give me another soft seltzer.
Dan's drinking Black Cherry Stop and Shop brand seltzer. That's two Stop and Shop plugs.
Yeah, Stop and Shop. Send the check.
Yeah. Well, this podcast is sponsored by Stop and Shop. And what were we talking about earlier?
iMovie.
And Apple iMovie.
Yeah. Apple iMovie.
Apple iMovie.
Check out Apple, guys, if you haven't.
Fucking piece of shit. I was editing my Instagram, stupid little Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
It was like a, what's the other one? Not Instagram.
TikTok?
No, before.
Snapchat.
Yeah.
Twitter.
Snapchat. I'd do like a Snapchat video,
mm-hmm.
but then I'd like edit it in iMovie and post it on Instagram. I had all these workarounds.
Yeah, that's like a format is like that, you know, that gradient bar that Snapchat has with that text. Like that's mainly what goes viral now.
Yeah.
Like I sit there, I talk to Tilson about this all the time, where it's like, we're working, you know, not fucking hard, but it's like, we're learning all this shit. And we're like, you know, we have like lav mics and fucking wireless packs for our phones. And we figured out like,
you got lapel mics.
Yeah. That's
I'm
like
thinking I want to do this with lapel mics. Cause then it's really like a chill thing, like where we're hanging.
Yeah.
Or would you, what do you think? As a sound guy, actually, this is a good question for you then.
Well, I think, I don't know. I don't know much about like the fucking, inner workings of mics. I know that that plug is an XLR, and I don't understand frequencies. I've been around it. I've hovered. I've looked over some shoulders, Thatcher.
Okay, you said, you know, you said
I've plugged in a few boards.
You've looked over some shoulders.
I know the word MIDI.
Okay. All right. Fair enough.
No, I know a good amount. I was just talking about this.
All right. Sorry. You were talking about Tilson. You and Tilson and it's
oh, no. It's
editing,
just like,
right?
You know, it's like, learn fucking 3 days of green screen or some effect or something that you don't know, and you put all this extra work into it, and you're like, I bought these fucking $150 lav mics so that, you know, I don't have to scream into my phone that's over there and hope it catches the whatever. And then a Snapchat video is what goes viral or whatever. How many times am I going to say whatever tonight?
It's fine. I say like way too much. I usually have a mini stroke once an episode and slur words. Like, I'm about a beer and a half in, so for sure I'm going to slur. A
little water on the keyboard. So, yeah. Start to short circuit a bit.
Just going to fuck something up.
But yeah, it's like there's like a it's, you know, native to,
do you know,
certain
why?
Social media platforms.
Yeah, because we don't speak that internet language, really. We're trying to learn how to, yeah, but we don't speak that English language. Right on cue, dude.
Perfect.
Did you hear, like, without, like, I just said I was going to do it and then did it inside a fucking a minute of saying it.
It's like he controls his own mouth or something.
I know.
It's crazy.
My mouth is faster than my brain.
Oh, 100%. I mean, for me, that was me agreeing, and I was like, say the other part.
Yeah.
Where you two agree.
Yeah. So, but. Yeah, we don't have the mind of a fucking 12-year-old.
Dude, it's like, I feel like I can...
I'm like, how is this? The fucking dances?
I feel like I can understand when someone's speaking Mandarin, but I don't know how to speak it. Does that make sense?
You can tell the difference between Mandarin,
like,
and...
I can notice, like, things where it's like, oh, that's a trend. That seems to be a thing. That seems to be a thing. Where it's like Snapchat videos with things that are like, girl or something.
I feel like that with TV shows. We're like, when I'm into it, and I obviously, like, I don't control. Sometimes I do feel like this is my universe. Like, you live in your own, he lives, and we're in this little Venn diagram of, like, they happen to overlap right now.
Yeah.
Because how do I even know you exist if you're not here? Like,
I said that
I
on the way
you,
here.
You know?
He said Thatcher Street, and I was like, is this a sting? Am I about to get shot in the back of the head?
So.
Who did I talk to on the phone?
But it's weird, like, when I kind of stop. When I feel like I'm not into a show anymore, it almost seems like everyone's not into that show. And it's obviously because it's probably just how the cookie crumbles. Like,
right,
the show
it's just like an energy.
It's not that good anymore, and everyone loses interest.
Do you mean,
like a television
show?
Yeah, or if I get into a show.
Yeah.
It's like you were saying, you speak that language. Oh, you can see when something's a trend.
Yes.
Like, I feel like that with TV shows where, like, I'll start getting into something and be like, oh, this is good. And then sure enough, I'm like, I knew this was good before all you motherfuckers caught on.
Yeah.
And it becomes a thing. And then when I kind of, if I don't make it through season two, it's almost like this, it's like the show's not going to make it through season two.
Yeah, it's like, all right, everybody wrap it up.
Maybe does season three and then it's like whatever, but I didn't even watch season three because I kind of, I don't know. Maybe,
yeah, season three
I knew
is always
in my gut because I just speak that language.
You had
but
to stop.
Yeah, it's like you see the trends, but you don't know how to capitalize
I feel on like, I, yeah, I feel like I understand that in like the reverse where like someone will tell me about something that they think is like this new thing. And it'll be brand new to me in that moment. And I'm like, wow, this is like almost like uncomfortable, unfamiliar thing. That's almost like in my head, I'm like, it's this independent artist. If it's a song or a fucking whatever it is. And then you go to it and like everybody's knows about it.
Do you remember Bumble?
Yeah.
Not Bumble. It was like
Plenty of Fish.
No, not the dating site. It was like TikTok before TikTok. There
Musical.ly. Dub Smash.
No, there was Musical.ly. And then before Musical.ly, there was like, not Keys, because Keys is a fucking porn site, but it was like Bees or it was like.
I remember
I've got some
Dub
videos
Smash,
on my
Musical.ly, TikTok.
It was
Vine.
It was just in between. It was exactly like.
They kept changing the name of like what TikTok became.
Yeah, it's like I was like, I was doing TikTok when it was fucking XYZ.
Yeah, I know a guy, he's a drummer who, shout out Jimmy Pemberton, he like
say that name again slower for my audience.
Jimmy Pemberton.
That's what I thought you said.
Jimmy Pemberton.
Jimmy
Pemberton.
Shout out to Jimmy Pemberton.
What was I going to say?
Musical.ly, TikTok.
Musical.ly. Yeah, so he got what was he telling me? I think he was telling me he got verified. He got like the blue check on like the tail end of Musical.ly into the switch of TikTok. So he has the verified badge.
But on something that's not even really that popular.
That's like a new company, yeah. But like it carried over somehow, and he has like some troubles with it, but he says like they not forgot about him, but they were like, oh, there are all these verified accounts from the old server. I don't fucking know how it works. Coding.
It's like I got like 10,000 followers on MySpace. I don't know if you guys know.
yeah.
Go check out my Woody Two Shoes MySpace. It's
but I mean, I would really fucking pop it off. That blue check mark. Not that like
it's pretty cool.
It's cool. It's fucking
cool.
It's weird. It's valued to money in some way or another, or at least importance some way.
It's like it's the cool club. You're like it's like a. You like get a little pseudo prom king fucking crown.
You'll stop and look. You're like sometimes
you're in the cool kid crowd.
Yeah,
cool kid crowd. I'm verified. I'm a valid citizen. KKK, the cool kid. I'm a valid citizen of the United States of America or of the world.
Yeah, it's like what the fuck. He's like, I can talk to like other verified accounts just because of the blue check mark. It's like
right.
That's sick. Like you get so much shit.
That
I don't know.
Dope.
I don't like. I guess I want a blue check. I mean,
Who doesn't want a fucking
blue check
mark?
Especially in comedy, not, acting, whatever we're doing here.
Yeah. We want to be comedies.
Yeah, we don't want a check mark.
Hear that? That's twice now. Three strikes, you're out. We want to be comedies.
Comedies
and
actors. But yeah,
all right.
Go ahead. Sorry.
Do you
it's a segment.
Keys? Nah. Do you have? We don't have to do it. We did one. I think I did one podcast where we didn't do it for like until like an hour and 20 minutes in. Sorry. Nice.
I got him.
This is the type of fucking segment.
I gotta stand up and take this coat off.
Brianna Woodward, very similar. But so far I've had one guest.
Who had keys?
Who pulled out a key.
Oh,
a key, singular.
Oh, that's so weird. I do have one key in that
And I was
pocket.
Like, what?
Whoops, sorry. Who had one key? What are they, in seventh grade?
Jamie Aird.
Oh.
I'll call him out because I've been busting his balls.
I'm sure
that's two in a row.
Grade. I don't know you.
I
bust
his
funny.
Balls. No, I was asking him. I was like, is that a Jamaican thing? Is that a you thing? Is it a black thing? Is it a, I don't know. Because like,
yeah,
I've never seen that before.
Did he have it around his neck with a land?
No,
like
he just doesn't
key?
Like shit in his pocket. Honestly, I respect his reasoning because playing golf, I have to have the tee in my ear.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have just my divot repair and my ball marker, and that's it.
Yeah,
I can't have shit in my pocket. My keys, everything, like anything, like nothing is in my pocket. It's got to be in my bag when I'm playing golf. So I kind of understand it when he's like driving. He doesn't want shit.
Yeah, I wish I didn't. I don't know what this segment is, but I wish I didn't have this fucking many keys. Oh,
just
yeah,
I just want to make a point that Mason pulled up images of keys.
What a producer
on our screen over there for us.
What? Yep. Jamie, pull that up. Look at those keys.
Let's see if her dance keys match those. So you got a skeleton? No.
All right. Isn't it crazy that you could just go get a key? Like, if you got the key to my house, you could just go get it made, and no one's gonna be like, what is this key to? And you could just walk into my house. Right?
Yeah, and I'm sure that happens more.
So simple. How's that not like...
I guess I've never thought of it like that. But, dude. With all the crime and serial killers...
That'd be such a simple... The judge would be like, sick move, dude. No, like, none of us thought of that.
Respect. Honestly, damn.
House arrest, but their house.
Yeah. All right. So
keys.
We don't have a name for this segment, and when enough people are watching this, they'll vote on a name for this. Or hey guys, this is this two weeks in a row I've done this actually. Hey guys, put in the YouTube comments.
Oh, that's good.
What you think we should name this segment?
Yeah. Can I throw out some idea? I don't know what the segment is. I feel like it's like a drum roll.
No, you just go through your keys. Tell me what each of them's for.
That's amazing.
And it usually generates interesting conversations.
Wow.
Yeah, I really liked that. I think it was a cool idea.
My God, this should be the whole podcast.
Sam, Sam Buck was busting my balls about this the first time. He's like, "This is so fucking dumb." And then 5 minutes later, we were like two keys in to his cold keychain, and we're like having a whole bunch of conversations. I was like,
"Dude, we're going we're going all night."
Hold on, I just choked on my own spit.
Oh no,
something from the key to his heart. That makes for good content.
So. Oh, good cough. All right. You know, it's great, a good cough during sex. When you go, hold on.
Yeah, hold on. Yeah.
Just clearing your throat is enough. Just like, yeah, baby.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Hold on. Let me wipe the sweat from you and me.
Yeah.
From my sweat.
Do you got a tissue? All right.
All right.
Keys.
Let's fucking do it.
Bust them out.
I literally was like, I don't know what this segment is, but I hope it's just going through my keys.
That's what it is.
All right.
No, we actually, I have you... Stab me with your sharpest.
Oh man,
key.
We're gonna play. What's that game?
From Alien.
Yeah.
Aliens. The second one. Which one do you like better?
I've never seen either of them. I haven't seen a lot of classic films. I've been like trying to catch up on classic films.
I like how Aliens is a classic film to you. I think classic films. You mean like just classic in the sense of like.
Classic
like
in a genre.
All-time classics. Like,
yeah, like
this is
our world.
Like, I just saw... I haven't even finished it, but I started... I'm halfway through One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest.
One of my friend's favorite movies.
Yeah, because Ratchet came on. Did you watch that on Netflix? It was like... I mean, yeah, if you...
Ratchet is...
Ratchet is Nurse Ratchet. From One Flew, whatever.
When she was young.
Yeah, and it's like they jokered her. They were like, ooh, prequel, and she's dark.
Well, arguably one of the most hated characters in all of movie lore.
She's a bitch, right?
So you just started watching the movie?
Yeah, I'm only at the middle.
I
just started freaking out about the game.
That movie does a great job of, like... So, my opinion, people are, dude, it was dumb. Like, that lady was so fucking, like... People say that about movies. It's like, look at you right now. You're emotional. You're, like, mad. You're worked up.
Yeah.
So... You're saying that movie sucked, yet
yeah,
the movie
like
did its job
because it evoked
emotion out of you. So, like, you may not even realize it, but the movie's good.
Yeah, I was just saying that today. We were watching – I forget we were watching.
It's causing you to get emotional.
Yeah. It's like – we were
just
watching –
You're not just stagnant about it.
My buddy had on Broad City of all things, and, like, the gym – like, one of the trainers that – like, you hate all of the – like, when you hate a character – and you aren't thinking of, like, the actor who's playing them. When you're just like, oh, I fucking hate this guy.
Yes.
Or like, oh, this guy's such a dude. Or like, whatever it is, when they make you feel like, oh, fuck
the
this.
The wife from Breaking Bad.
Yes. Yes. Uh-huh.
Fuck it. What's her name? Skyler.
Skyler.
Yeah, they gave her a fucking terror. Dude, he gave her such a shitty name,
It's
too.
A good name.
What a
It's a good bad name,
What
yeah.
a good bad name that
and
is.
And she's a bitch.
Skyler.
And she fucks the boss.
She's such a... Did she fuck the boss?
She fucks the boss, I think.
No, I think she was gonna... Oh, maybe she did.
Like, whoever that other
she
guy
had, like,
is.
The one-off with him, right?
Yeah, yeah. Because
he's, like, obsessed with her. And he's such a pain in the ass, too.
I'd be nervous if my husband started selling meth. I'd be like, you gotta go to chemo.
Yeah. No, but I'm saying the boss was obsessed with her and he
was
all this bullshit.
Yeah, because she's like a horrible bitch character.
Yeah, she fucking sucks. So that's my point. The Nurse Ratched is very much like that, where by the end of it,
you hate her.
Strong opinions of this.
Right.
Movie.
Man, that's
all right.
It's good stuff.
You just made me think of something. We haven't even fucking gone into
you
one.
You go, pull out your wallet, segment two.
Look at how fucking awesome this segment is, dude. We haven't even got into one key yet. No, this just made me think of something. I'm going to do a, it's not a spinoff. It's not a ripoff. It's just an idea, but it's like a watch party, right? I want to do a 6-part podcast series. Like, it's called, I guess it's a mini series. So
yeah.
It's just a 6-part series.
A limited series.
Limited podcast series. For Christmas, I just got a DVD 6-pack of like 6 of the corniest like movies about dragons. And one of them's like a Beowulf movie. One of them is called Merlin and the Warlocks of blah blah blah.
Are they like those romance?
One of them's Beastmaster. I actually have seen, I think, Beastmaster. I don't remember it.
I can't get into wolves.
Well, I want to have four comedians.
Yeah.
Sit on the couches and two chairs.
This is a perfect mics, place for that format.
Right?
Yeah.
And watch those each movie and just sit here and like with picture in picture, you know, us on the couch.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Watching the movie, but the movie will be on the big screen. And then we just sit there and talk shit like Mystery Science Theater 3000.
Yeah, I was going to say, like,
a lot of people. I never got to. I said rip off, spoof, blah, blah, blah. This is how my brain works. It's like Quentin Tarantino. I bring you back.
Oh, my God, I'm the same way.
To the point at the beginning.
Yeah.
My brother's like, why didn't you lead with that? I'm like, no, it's not how.
I'm like, you had to know the character first.
Exactly, yes. Yes, exactly.
You had to learn the character.
But yeah, it's basically like a Mystery Science Theater 3000.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's that shit's great.
Where four of us just sit here.
I don't even know what those movies are. Like, I couldn't fathom.
That's the point. I don't either.
Okay. All right.
You know
yeah.
what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. That's I thought you were idea. Like, I got the best six Beowulf shittiest. One through
no,
three.
No. All right. I was going to run upstairs and grab you. I'll show you the DVD after. But it's like, it's basically like, it's like, dragons and demons and folk, you know what I mean? It's like the best six pack fucking.
Yeah, it's really like romantic like novels for like moms and CVS, but fucking dragons and wolves.
For dragon movies, yeah, exactly.
For you.
Yeah, but he knew, like he wasn't like, you'll love this.
Okay.
He knew that it was like,
he was like,
these
hey.
Movies are corny. I bet you'd enjoy. And I thought like right off the bat, I was like, oh, this would be perfect. Because yeah, that's what Mystery Science Theater 3000
yeah,
is.
Yeah, it's all
I've
weird
actually
shit.
Seen one of the mysteries, one of the most recent series they did on Netflix, the movie Mac
oh,
and
yeah,
Me.
Oh, yeah, they brought it back.
I remember seeing Mac and Me as a little kid. It was Mac like an E.T. Me. Ripoff.
Isn't it all like copyright or like they're not, like it's not copywritten shit they do? Or do they like, because it's all old weird shit sometimes.
I'm sure
it?
They pay for the licensing.
Yeah, we're talking licensing.
But didn't you say there's a workaround where you just speed it up and slow it
yeah,
down?
Yeah, you go 0.2 on the speed.
Go. And then, you know, the algorithm doesn't get it. Like, Action Bronson watches Ancient Aliens.
I know, I was just thinking of
so
that.
So I'm saying,
yeah,
how does
yeah,
he
yeah.
get away with that, dude? He's obviously yeah. not fucking, he's smoking weed and watching Ancient Aliens.
Right, yeah.
Pretty sure the History Channel isn't signing off on that shit.
Oh, yeah, it's History Channel. They're not pumped.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
There's got to be a workaround.
Yeah.
So we, I'm saying we can do it.
Oh yeah, we got it. I just like you like sparked my brain. I'm like, you can fucking do so much in here.
I'm gonna maybe start leasing the space.
That's
out.
Literally the thought I had in my mind. I was like, I don't want to say it on air so I don't blow your business model. But you can fucking rent this bitch out.
Yeah. So episode
I don't talk like
now
that
we
normal.
Know episode 8, which just won't be released for a while. But I'm probably yeah eventually like if because I mean with. You know, the way the everything is, we're like shut down and
yeah.
people I'm sure want to produce stuff, but everybody's doing Zoom shit on their laptops. And I'm just like, I know you, that's not what you want to be doing.
This is like
when the way you want to be doing it.
Yeah. I mean, first off, that seems horrible. And we were talking about it before where it's like, if you were a comic where like you were making money from, you know, you were at least a local headliner making money from corporate shows and, you know, enough shows throughout the week and like a headlining gigs and hosting, you know, all over where that was your
which would
income.
Be great.
It would be dope, but also they had to do Zoom shows given they were getting paid, you know, $1,000, $2,000, $5,000, whatever. I don't know how much a corporate is, but I've heard they're big and they sound like a nightmare. Every fucking thing. It's like, it sounds like hell. It's
yeah.
like being on a live
but
on
like,
Instagram.
Do it to pay your bills. It's almost like the acting thing. They're like, you want kind of want to do print and commercial stuff because that
yeah.
will just pay you residuals. Like,
right.
That'll pay your bills. And then you can fucking have the free time to go do auditions, et cetera,
yeah,
et cetera.
Yeah, yeah,
I
yeah.
feel like that's how corporate gigs are with comedy.
Right.
Where it's like, look, they're going to suck. And I've been booked like once. I've been really... It was in comedy for a year before it got shut down.
Yeah.
It technically started 2 years ago.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I consider myself a year and a half, I
yeah,
guess.
Yeah, I think I'm like
it.
Four, I say. Or like I'm like five or something.
So,
but
I mean, I
whatever
but,
this fucking year was.
But from what I hear is like. Yeah, dude,
right, I'm like, you know.
Yeah, I'm speaking like I fucking.
People. Who, well, no, that's what I'm saying. It's like, luckily, I don't make my money from doing Zoom comedy or have to. You know what I mean? Maybe
yeah.
it's different if. That is the way you do it, and it's like, if you get paid a bunch of money to talk into your fucking laptop for a half hour, maybe it's not so bad. But to me, that sounds like a nightmare. I did one roast through Irish when he was doing like the roast battles over Zoom. And like, it was good and people were laughing, all the people in the Zoom. But like, I just didn't like it whatsoever. I felt so uncomfortable.
It feels impersonal.
I can't, and I'm so lucky because
very controversial topic amongst comedians, by the way, is Zoom versus no Zoom.
Yeah, I don't know
why. How do you feel about Zoom? Mason's thumbs down.
Oh, I'm way thumbs down.
As a person consuming content, I don't like consuming Zoom content.
If it's a pod or like you say it's like a talk show and it's almost like a panel, I'd rather you like.
If it's an interview.
Yeah, I'd rather you like talk me through a bit, even if we do it with like that facade up, you know what I mean? Rather than, okay, go.
Try to do 5
yeah,
minutes.
Yeah, it's like, this is not the way this was created.
In front of a crowd.
This was not the fucking way it was started.
Yeah.
I think that's getting darker and more romantic in here.
I was just about to let you know you're looking kind of dark.
Is it?
A little bit.
All right, I'll turn the light.
Well, sometimes it, when it's,
you can still see.
When it's completely dark outside, it looks fine without any lights on. But,
oh, you didn't even turn a light on.
No, that light goes on. It just takes a second.
Oh, that's much better.
Right?
Much better. Yeah, there we go.
That's so funny. He was thinking it. I was thinking it.
Yeah.
You just said it?
It just snapped in all of it where we were like, it is dark, huh?
Yeah,
it's we're like, in the dusk is kind of like the hardest time to see.
Dusk is the worst.
And, yeah, dusk. Dusk's a motherfucker. Yeah. Unless you're driving into the sun in the morning. That's pretty rough, too.
Yeah.
Yep. All right. Keys.
Keys. Here we go.
Let me just pound this.
I'm going to take a bite of a cookie.
The fire.
Kelly, these cookies are delicious.
All right. We'll start with.
Car.
It's a Toyota 2005 Highlander.
You get it new?
No, I bought it from my father.
Yep.
And I was actually just telling Mason about this, where like I have literally the tape with the auxiliary cord that like you put in to listen to an iPhone or whatever music. And he was like baffled by that. And I was telling him, like, when I got this car, my other car shit the bed on the Mass Pike on the side of the road, like, blew a gasket, just was ruined forever.
Producer Andy's car just shit the bed.
Yeah,
the transmission.
Such a horrible day.
Like Christmas.
Ugh, it's the worst. But I get this car, and I was telling Mason, like, my dad bought this car relatively new. Like, he bought it in, like, maybe 08 or something. It's like an 05.
Yep.
And back then, I was like, wow, we got a new, cool car. This is a fucking nice car. All the shit. And I'm getting it from him now, and I'm like, I'm going to have, like, a nice car. And I get in, and
that's your last memory of it?
Yeah. And I'm like, ah, fuck, this thing doesn't have anything. I drive my girlfriend's car. It's, like, a 2015 Corolla, and it's, like, you know, it stops traffic for you when you're backing up. It's fucking insane.
Yeah, my car before this was a 2003 Ford Explorer.
Yeah.
I fucking hated that thing.
It's weird.
And I had the tape.
With
the auxiliary thing.
Yeah, so that doesn't even work right now because I don't have a fucking dongle for my lightning cable, the goddamn quarter-inch thing. Fuck Apple.
I'm sorry.
Dongle.
What's a dongle?
A dongle. It's the thing that takes it's an adapter that takes your average headphone, eighth-inch jack, and you put the adapter on that end. You put the male end into the female end.
Makes it a quarter-inch jack?
Makes it a no, it turns it into a lightning cable like the iPhone, like for the bottom.
Oh,
so you can listen to music.
Oh, because
I don't
dongle.
Dongle. That's what it's called.
I
dongle a lot.
I knew it was something along those lines, but specifically, I know exactly now what you're talking about.
I always say it like everyone's like, right, a dongle, and I always say dongle, and we're always right here where it's like, what?
Yeah,
dongle.
Yeah,
anyway, also. Fuck Apple.
You don't have to. The two of us are on the same page.
They got a goddamn... The new iPhone, it comes with a charger, right?
Yeah.
No wall adapter. Brand new. They used to go from USB. You know the normal USB?
Yeah.
It's like rectangle and shit, whatever. Yeah. I don't have it on me. It's USB-C. It's a completely different thing. And they don't give you the adapter.
So I just have this charger that goes to nothing in my fucking house right now until I buy the USB-C adapter. And to get a good one, it's like $40. And you know what?
We should just do a podcast where the two of us just bitch once a week.
Oh, dude, I'm like an old Jewish
bitch
woman.
And complain about shit.
Dude, Thatcher, ask my wife. I literally, 2 weeks ago, I told Carrie I wanted to start a podcast called Mason Complains About Everything. And I just wanted to sit and bitch.
That's all we do. We just judge things and criticize it and go, why would you do it that way?
Yeah. We're gonna get a cease and desist from Apple five podcasts in because it's just gonna be like an hour of Apple bashing podcast.
It just says,
I do.
I love bitching.
Well, I want to have two podcasts. I want to have one podcast where I have a guest every week, and then I want to have one weekly one where I just do it with the same exact person, where it's just
like a morning
total
show
just
type
rant.
Thing.
You know, not like how Bert Kreischer has his, but then he does the one with Tom. Like
right.
Tom's
yeah,
got
yeah,
the one
yeah,
with
yeah.
his wife, so but then better. They do the one with the two of them where it's just every week. And it's essentially just Bert rambling and then Tom kind of just like setting him up.
Yeah, for sure. Because
I feel like I'm that kind of personality where I interrupt people so much.
Same.
I talk so much over people. So I need a personality. My buddy Ben, he's not working, and I got to talk to him. He might still be up for it, but he's the type of personality where it's just like, just set me up. Let me fucking go.
Yeah.
Spew my ridiculous thoughts. Then you call me out on my bullshit. Then we laugh about it, and then I interrupt you, and then I do it when we do it all over again.
Thatcher, I think me and you have a lot in common in the sense that we say a thing confidently.
So confidently.
The way we interpret it.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Like
you
the way
fucking
like
know it.
Through the translation of my brain and like whatever it is with your brain, the way it comes out of your mouth.
Yep.
People like almost get it.
Yeah.
But there's always a double check. It's always like, what?
Yeah, I feel like it's like,
or if it's a close friend, they're like, no,
I
that's
describe,
wrong.
Yeah, I describe it like Will Ferrell. Like that's kind of my sense of humor too.
Oh,
it's
yeah,
like
yeah,
Will
yeah,
Ferrell
yeah,
humor,
yeah, yeah.
Where it's like, in the movie, everybody else is a normal human being, and he's like this ridiculous caricature of a person.
Yeah,
and he'll say a thing, and nobody's like, what? Like you can't say like it's just like you're just allowed. Because of the movie, you're allowed to do whatever you want inside
in
the
world
the,
of it. The
world
of
this
yeah.
movie, like a Ron Burgundy. Even though I mean that's like still like an over the top version of how like those guys were
back
then.
But he acts what he thinks is normal in this normal society.
Yeah, or like in just I don't know. Name your fucking Will Ferrell movie where it's just like he just gets away with saying the dumbest things.
Right.
And no one really calls him out on it because that's who he is in the movie. And it's just like, and that's kind of that's how I treat my humor. And like you said, the people who get that are just like, oh, right. That's a thing. But people who don't know us are like, I think this guy's half retarded.
Yeah. My friends have a thing called, they go, oh, we speak, or we're Danslators instead of trans. They go, oh, we're Danslators. Because I'll get going on something.
Say I speak fluent Dan. I'll say that about someone.
It's
like,
funny. You caught it earlier. I go, Jimmy Pemberton. You go, say it slower for everyone now. And you go, you actually
I was Dan's lady for the audience.
You go for the audience
exactly.
Yeah. It's like when the sign language interpreter.
Yep.
I don't know where I was going with that. I just said sign language interpreter.
Same
anyway.
Thing.
Keys. So that's my car.
Look at this. We're
only one key deep.
People, you want to knock the fucking key segment all you want.
Dude, the key segment's hot.
We're only one key deep. And
one
we're
key deep.
Fucking talking about chargers. We're talking about Danslators. We're talking about...
We're talking tech.
Fuck Apple tech.
Fuck Apple.
All the good stuff. We're starting podcasts.
Yeah, we are. Yeah.
I mean, Jesus Christ. Dude.
Check out the three he's invented already.
We're on fire today. Episode. Oh, real quick. Because I was going to mention it when I was lighting the things before, but then I started talking about the podcast studio and then the different podcast studio setups. And then next thing you know,
we're off
and running. Dan brought his custom Dan Hall lighters.
Just a picture of me.
What is the?
Oh, I go, yeah, baby.
Yeah, baby.
I'm gonna kill myself one day to that sound, but. It must be like the pina colada thing for the pina colada guy, where it's like, oh, it's a guy who wrote pina colada.
At the end of every single one of your videos,
it's the audio signature.
You need to put this image and you going, yeah, baby.
Yeah, baby.
It's like, no, you know, yeah, that's, you know, that's at the end idea. Of fucking every It's Always Sunny?
Yeah.
Like they, or at the end of every like the Simpsons, production, the kickball hits
yeah,
the
production
or,
bumper for
you
it.
You gotta have, that's yeah, your signature.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah. Yeah, baby.
Yeah, I have my niece saying
and by
it.
The way, when you guys see that at the end of Dan's videos from now on.
It's fucking Thatcher.
I get credit for it. But anyway, right. Thanks to Dan for.
Yeah. You can buy one of those lighters with my face on it and nothing else for $3. And I'm still learning how to ship things in the mail.
So hit Dan up on
so
Venmo
you
and you
will
can
get
them a yeah, baby ladder.
Next year. Yeah.
It's the yeah, baby ladder.
Yeah.
Yeah, baby.
It's just awkwardness. That's what it, people do the voice to me. And then I'm like, it's just me uncomfortable in public. That's why I go into myself and it comes out. And I'm like, ah, I'm sorry, I'm here.
Yeah.
That's the whole thing. I'm just like, I don't want to. Oh, look, we're pulling me up. This is how I think my funeral is going to be, where everyone's just going to stand around and look at all my videos and go, he thought these were funny.
Dude, I kind of want that for my funeral. Like the Andy Kaufman at the end of the, have you seen Man in the Moon?
Yeah. What does he do?
He fucking he has a video stuff? Where he's looking around. He's like, he's pointing out people. He's like, yeah. Hey, Dan,
oh,
come
man.
On, man.
That's
cheer
great.
Up, whatever. He's like, all right, now I want everyone to sing along. He starts singing a song, and he's like, all right, you over there.
Oh, my
he's
God.
Like pretending like he's actually looking, because whatever.
It yeah,
looks
yeah,
like he's
yeah,
actually
yeah,
looking
yeah.
at
yeah.
you. Everybody's just in the fucking audience singing and crying. It's
yeah, I'm like, is that horrifying or charming?
It's kind of cool.
Yeah, just the addressing part, because like people do like video wills, but like
I
to be like, what's up, dumb shirt?
Yeah.
Just doing bad crowd work at your funeral.
I definitely cannot remember the bit, but I did have some stupid bit about that.
About bad jokes.
Yeah. Oh, but like, oh, but the bit is like turns out I'm like a dick my whole life and everyone hates me. So there's no one in the audience. So I'm like pointing. I'm like, hey, you chick. But like, there's two people there. And it's just one of them's like, just a person who like, my friend who had to fucking go to interpret the will.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? So it's literally just like, there's nobody there. It's just,
yeah, that's
like,
amazing.
Come on, everybody, sing along. And it's just like, the priest is just like,
Just
oh like,
man. He goes, I get it. This guy's a dick. I mean, look at his video, Will.
Exactly.
Roasting everybody all the time.
Yeah. So.
Fuck, hold on. I lost my joint, I think. So I was just going to find that. Oh, I'm sitting on it the whole time. I laid a joint. All right. So, Keith. So the only other story I have about this is, I was doing a comedy show at the Comedy Attic in Worcester. Is that what it's called now? The old place upstairs there? At the Pot Grill. I was doing comedy. Great night. Great set upstairs before outside. Yeah, pre-COVID. I was doing a show. Great show. Feeling hot. Didn't bomb. That's always a good show. And I come out and there's a note on my car, like my windshield. And I noticed that the entire left side of my car has just been completely smashed. It just like someone clearly like dragged the side of their car on my car. And, there was a note, and I was like, oh, okay, well, at least they left a note. And I opened the letter or note or whatever, and it's like, hi, we live upstairs. We heard someone hit your car. So just text us when you get here. We have pieces of your car. There's like a serial number. Maybe we can, I don't know, they can find them from the serial number. And that was it. And my insurance was like, no.
I was waiting for you to be like, and it turned out it was actually my neighbor.
No, it was literally just on a random street. I was so mad. Like, I just had to eat
sucks.
It. It's like, I just have a giant dent in my car. It also lets me, like, it's like a fucking war scar. I'm like, I'm not afraid to cut you off, clearly.
I got jumped in high school because my cousin was running his mouth.
Oh,
and
no.
My entire windshield got shattered. And I told my parents that I was like, oh, fucking, I went into Stop and Shop and I came
like,
out.
Fuck,
I was like,
dude,
who
I have
would
no idea.
Do this?
Dude, that was the biggest excuse where you're like, I have
no clue
how this happened. I wasn't even present when this happened. That's the best. That's the best one.
My 2003 Explorer, someone smashed it with a brick.
Yeah.
Stole $600 out of my wallet.
Damn.
Left the Mega Millions, like $600 million Mega Millions lottery ticket, potential winner. Like, you know, because it was, well, dude. Yeah, because I was like,
potential
winner. I'm going to fucking win the lottery. This dumbass fucking, good. Yeah, take the $600.
That would have been great.
That would have been the best story in the world. This dumbass didn't take the ticket.
Yeah.
I win the fucking lottery. Like,
that would have been
idiot.
Sick. Take the car.
I was sitting as far away as you, like you and I sitting here, that window, my car's parked. If we're on the first floor of the house, my car's parked basically behind where that TV is, like right there.
Yeah.
And I like heard something. I was like, oh, that's crazy. I was like, that sounded like someone broke into your neighbor's house or something. I was like, we were almost like, do you hear? Like, and we were like, I don't know. You know, it's like broken glass, but almost feel like there was more than one person.
Yeah.
Cause to have the audacity, like smash a window and then like patiently, like,
hold on.
Like, cause he didn't just grab my wallet and run. He opened my wallet.
Yeah. He sifted,
took the money out, put my wallet back. And left, which means there must have been a guy on lookout like, they're not even moving. They're still watching cartoons.
Yeah.
What the fuck? I felt so stupid.
I've had that. Yeah, I've had that. Like, I didn't get money stuff. I had a vape stolen from me and a fanny pack that said, let's party. And I always think of the guy. It had like a bunch of weed shit. It was like this little case here, but it was a fanny pack. And it was just like, you know, overly loud of a fanny pack, and I just think it's funny that this guy went back to like his little crew of people and was like, I got a Snoop Dogg vape pen and a fanny pack from this kid. And then another time I heard a guy breaking into my car. It wasn't breaking in, I just didn't lock my doors because I was a dummy, but I just heard the car over. I was like, why is my dad in the car? And I went out, and it was just a guy, he's running down the street and took like old scratch tickets, like all my losing scratch tickets. And like, you could tell he like sifted through everything. And I had, at the time, it was a brand tax new breaks. DSLR. Yeah. Yeah. I'm getting that tax break when I finally hit, I had a brand new DSLR camera, like in the center, and like, he just missed it. What an idiot.
Yeah.
What a dummy.
My friends always bust my balls because I don't really lock my car.
Neither do I. Much.
Not in this area. Like, around here, like, come on. And also, I give people, there's a quote from a movie, and I was like, oh, yeah, whatever. But it's like, you give humanity the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah, and for I don't really part. Have that much shit in there.
A, I left my wallet visible. B, my car was locked when they did it. So it's like, what the fuck? Like, if someone wants it that bad, locking your car, they're going to smash the window with a brick.
Yeah, I'm such a dick sitting here. I'm like, same story. I unlocked my car. They got none of my valuable things. Same story.
I also sit there and I go, you know what? I deserve it because I believe in karma.
100%.
I believe in karma. And as kids, we fucking went out in the middle of the night and snuck around into open. We're seeing which cars were open. We got a couple bucks here and there for cigarettes.
Yeah.
You know, some dollars out of center consoles. My cousin stole a Nintendo 64 or Nintendo fucking whatever out of some lady's trunk. And I was like, you're a fucking dick, dude. I felt really bad about that one. I was like, it's probably like someone's Christmas present. Yeah. You just fucking stole.
I wasn't fast enough.
And I felt so bad about that one. So honestly, when that $600 got stolen immediately, I was like, you know what, motherfucker?
I do that with everything in my life where I'm like, all right, well, this shitty thing I did is even now. I'm back to neutral on this.
We're square.
Yeah. All right, higher power. You son of a bitch. I was never fast enough to go on break-ins. I went on like a few and then my friends stopped taking me and then they all got arrested and had probation in ninth grade. But
adrenaline's a motherfucker because why else are you really doing it?
I was fat and scared. I was always the kid that was there, but I was on my bike far away. You know what I mean? Yeah. In a Scally cap and Dropkick Murphy shirt, like a douche.
Dress like you should be robbing shit,
dude.
What Dropkick Murphy shirt.
Ugh, I was the worst. If I could punch anyone, it'd be me.
Were you wearing that in the movie with your Scally cap?
No, I was wearing like a black hoodie. You know what's funny is there's like a, I think I have a black eye in Here Comes the Boom for the 2 seconds.
I want to watch that afterwards.
It's hard
to
find.
We'll watch each other's movie scenes
afterwards. It'll take us 6 seconds total.
Yeah, but exactly, literally.
So have you ever heard of the world's biggest pillow fight? I'm sorry, we'll get back to my keys after this. I'm like excited about the keys.
Yes, but this is what it does. It just, you know, the conversation goes.
Oh yeah,
where
we got here from
there's,
there.
There's exactly. Yeah. There's no mandatory. That's the beauty.
Like, we
got
to get back.
That's
to
why.
The keys.
That's why fucking Zoom doesn't work because Zoom would have turned this whole interaction into an interview.
Right.
The keys thing wouldn't flow organically. Yeah. It's not a hang. It's just me interviewing Dan Hall. It's not me hanging out smoking weed with Dan. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, I hate the sound of internet audio too. There's a very specific like clippy internet audio.
Yeah.
Zooms, that's just horrendous. Am I saying very obvious things here? I'm like, I hate bad sound.
No, I think a lot of people feel that way.
Dude, so as someone who not only has a podcast, but takes a lot of podcasts in.
Yeah.
Like the Bill Burt podcast, which is Bill Burr and Burt Kreischer.
Was fantastic.
It's a professional podcast. It's a great podcast, but the audio quality is dog shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It sounds like he's just talking into his laptop.
Yeah, that's even worse. I hate Zoom podcasts. Even worse. We've talked about this multiple times.
At least headphones with a mic better than just screaming into the laptop.
We've talked about this multiple times, but I watched that podcast and I thought it was great because the two of them were hanging out, shooting the shit in person, and the minute they went to Zoom format, it's not even about the audio quality, it's just about it's just so impersonal. It takes that,
it's horrendous.
It takes a dynamic away from that hang that just makes it different.
Here, it's like this. Have you ever been listening to a podcast or music or whatever in your headphones, like cleaning your house, and you don't have anything else on and there's no other noise, and you like stop the podcast for a second and you like, oh yeah, I'm just walking around in silence right now,
yeah,
and I'm tricking my brain. That's what I feel like. What were we talking about? Like literally, what were we just talking about?
We were talking about Zoom.
Zoom, podcast, yeah, that's what Zoom does, because it's like, yes, this is like a call sort of. I mean, when I do a phone call, it's like, unless it's for like a job interview and I'm freaking out about it, it's like
you're
hello,
listening to a Jerky Boys tape.
Yeah, it's fucking, I just think like, you're not, I don't know. Being in the room with someone, you can at least, and there's like lag or latency and shit that's like
we've
1 second off.
We've talked about this so much, I'm going to change the name of this to the Anti-Zoom Podcast.
Oh, it's so bad.
I talk about it so much.
I do it too.
I feel like I'm very passionate about it, I guess. I don't know. Same. Meanwhile,
like
there's plenty
awesome
of people who are just killing it, Dude, I had the conversation with Brianna Woodward last week, and she's fucking zooming her ass off, and she loves it.
Yeah, I mean, if you can do it and you're comfortable, I'm like not a comfortable comedian. I get stage fright still going on stage, like when we were doing comedy. Yeah. I'm not one of the comics that's like, you know, I don't understand comics that are like, that run the light. I mean, I get if you're like killing and like you fucking, you know. But
you just
like,
want to get that joke out that badly.
Yeah, it's like how like, fucking badly. Like when they go like 5 minutes over, and like there are stipulations and variables to who the person is and where the show is and shit.
Mason,
but it's like, but it's like, what the fuck?
Can I get another one of these?
A shark tracker.
Shark
brought
tracker,
to you by
please.
A shark tracker.
All right, run in the light.
Guys
that go 5 minutes over. You don't understand.
Yeah. It's like, I'm just not that person. I guess that's what I'm trying to say. Is like. And on Zoom, I feel like you have to be, like, wanting to be there, or else it's, like you were saying earlier, it's like, if you're out of a show, I mean, I know you're talking about television shows, but, like, if anyone's energy is off, and, like, it just, fucking, I hate Zoom, I don't know what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, I agree.
You get it? I don't know.
I'm on the same page.
For the record, I have a hockey game at 7:30, I said I wasn't going to drink, and now this is my third shark tracker.
Dude, we're puck bros.
I just hope I don't.
Is that what
I'm
they do in hockey?
Your game and go chirp.
Puck bros.
I'm gonna do that when I get there. I'm like, what's up, puck bros?
Puck bros. Right? Let me pull your shirt over your head and kiss you or something. I can't skate.
You said you wouldn't kiss him anyway, though. You're not really a mouth guy.
No.
I think that's the exact quote.
Yeah, no, I hate mouth. That's funny
you
say that.
I'm not a mouth guy.
I don't like mouths in general. You know how people like don't have like a thing with eyes or like
I don't like
ears?
Feet.
Yeah, so feet, yeah. We're the polar opposite, but that's fine.
Huh?
I said we're the polar opposite, but that's fine.
You like your feet?
No.
Feet guy?
I could take them or leave them. I don't care. If they're in the equation, it's fine.
So you love Quentin Tarantino movies then?
Well, yeah. I mean, I finished within the first 10 to 15 minutes of Kill Bill. When she's in the Jeep, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah. or like From Dusk Till Dawn. Oh, yeah. Can you just think about it? You're a foot man, right? You love feet.
I don't.
You got a foot fetish, and Selma Hayek is doing a strip dance on a table. Who cares about? Yeah, I get like he's not really in the strip club, and there's a production crew around.
Right. But still,
but like Salma Hayek is half naked.
Yeah,
doing a belly dance and on a table in front of you. Sticks her foot in your mouth and pours like whiskey or apple juice or whatever the fuck it was down her leg into your mouth.
Quentin Tarantino.
Tell me
he did
not
actually.
Go
That's
back
little...
to his trailer and just fucking.
Yeah, dude, he's a fucking weird dude. Great film director guy, weirdo writer. Did he write all of them?
Yeah.
Wow.
All of those. He also wrote True Romance.
I've never seen that. That's another one that everyone's like, what?
It's a good one.
It has all the people I like in it, other than...
But I've mentioned that to people. I'm like, about Quentin Tarantino being a foot guy, and they're like, really? And I go look at all of his movies post...
Oh, yeah.
Like, Harvey Keitel and fucking Tim Roth aren't showing their feet in...
Right.
In...
He's not J&O to fucking...
The fucking... The other guys. What the fuck's the name of the Tarantino movie? His first
Reservoir
one.
Dogs?
Reservoir Dogs. I had an R in my head, but
I was like, "You talking about the other guys? Are we back to Wolf
No, it was a joke. It was a joke. Like there's no feet in Reservoir Dogs, but like every movie after that.
I never watched it.
Uma Thurman barefoot dancing around in her house in Pulp Fiction. Pulp there's Fiction. Bare feet in Pulp Fiction. Jackie Brown, she's barefoot in her house.
It'd be like a lady just like took her shirt off in a scene.
Wiggle your left, wiggle your right toe. In From Dusk Till Dawn, he literally has Salma Hayek's feet in his mouth. In the most recent one, Hollywood. The Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, yes. You got the little hippie girl.
Yeah,
she's got a dirty ass feet out there.
What's that fucking thing where Kurt Russell kills them? It's like the Murder House movies. Her foot flies off in that movie. Spoilers. But
is she barefoot at one point?
I don't know, but they focus.
I'm trying to think. Are there toes in Hateful Eight? Google. Listen, this is Mason's first task as guest producer. Are there toe shots in Hateful Eight?
No, there's not. I just know that movie.
All right.
But I'll show you.
This might debunk my theory.
Mason's the Mr. Toe of the internet.
Well, maybe it's just impossible. Like he thought about it. He's like, I just can't fit it in. I just can't.
Yeah, he's like,
there's no way I can convince anyone to take their shoes off. They're going to be like, where? Like he's actually trying to get it in. And the actors are like,
they go, we're in a winter scene. We're trapped in a cabin.
What's that photo on the top?
Well, that's not in.
Oh, damn. I thought this was
just type in foot to Google.
That's what I'm thinking.
I'll be right back.
But if you look,
the actress
was look right here, though, he's Quentin Tarantino's foot fetish.
Yeah, it's a thing.
Yeah, it's a thing.
It's like just weird enough that it's quirky.
The chick,
because it's not that degrading, I guess.
Well, he does it tastefully.
Sure,
but feet are gross to me. I don't like. I don't know what it is.
Into feet as much as like boobs or ass.
Yeah, like I would never want to put my mouth on someone's feet.
Right. Ew.
Exactly. That's what
feet are gross. I hate them now. Thank you, Thatcher, for cleansing me of the toe. Fuck. They're so disgusting. They look like long hands. I'm freaking out, guys.
Dude,
pull the feet down.
I can tell you. Get rid of the images.
Get rid of the feet.
Get rid of them. Pull up titties.
Yeah, let's get hard in here, baby. We're in the chapel. We're in the goddamn stained glass.
You just pulled up porn.
Boobs.
I was trying to keep this computer clean. I was trying to keep all that shit on my laptop, dude. Oh, my God.
That must have been so creepy for everyone watching is like you guys were laughing and I was just looking.
Yeah.
I realized I stopped laughing and I was like, you got to laugh, you lunatic. Or you seem like a creep. I'm like, I'll be right back, guys. Give me 5 minutes tops.
We'll be back after
these
messages.
Do you have a printer?
And then it's just like the podcast just cuts. And then we're all of a sudden we're talking about Dan. Yeah, we're just talking about Dan's keys again. Well,
this key's to my sister's house.
Oh, Oh,
we're cooking, baby. What did I do with my keys?
We're having fun. Yeah, where are your keys? What time? How far in are we?
You're an hour and 38 minutes.
We're an hour and 38 minutes into this fucking thing,
dude. I'm that fun,
dude. Well, we went almost 2 hours with Brianna. It happens.
I got a tile for Christmas.
All right, we
got
to stay focused, dude. We got to get through this keys segment because we got to.
I got one in my wallet. I forget shit everywhere, dude. This is the best key ever. So
my that's
it's, I don't know how to stop it.
Wait, does that help you find your phone or help you find your keys or both?
So from my phone,
you can find your keys.
I can find my keys.
And from your keys,
and from my keys, I can find my phone.
Oh shit, dude! What's that called? I gotta write this down. What?
Tile. Double entendre. Tile. God forbid that you lose both.
Right. That's in my hold on just a second there, cowboy.
I just lost my keys. Like, I lost my keys a couple weeks ago at hockey somehow.
Dude.
And they flat, I have not turned up.
Somehow is like my main word in life.
Down to a spare.
Yeah.
My spare key for my truck and one key for my trailer, for my construction trailer.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't have a house key.
You go, I don't actually live here. I live in a trailer open.
Yeah, so if someone decides to come up here and lock this for some reason,
listen,
I'm gonna get stuck
Ted.
Outside in the cold. But I've thought that I locked my key in my car and had like a fucking anxiety attack, like full blown nervous wreck for 10 seconds until I found the key and was like, oh my God.
Oh my God, that's
my
whole day.
I almost locked myself out of my car.
Me and my girlfriend
forever.
Are a match made in heaven because we're just running around our house all morning being like, where the fuck did I put my key? Why are they all off the chain?
Why is it
reason?
In the place that I think I always put it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The problem is, too, is like, I'll be like organizing shit and being like, I'm going to be organized guy now and not forget stuff and know where to put stuff back in their places. And then I forget where I like put the thing that I'm looking for
I
clean it.
I need a phone reminder to remind me to buy an organizer to write down the things to write down, like to remind me to write down reminders.
100%. I'm always like, I should write on my hand to write in my phone later.
Yeah, I should. Yeah, I got to remind myself to go buy a reminder book.
So I call my mom. I'm like, call me in 20 minutes. Tell me this thought I have.
I say that to people all the time. I'm like, hey, remind me later about this. And he's like, why don't you just write? I'm like, it's not how it works, dude.
Yeah, I'm like,
I'm
driving and I have it. It's coming out all once.
Why don't you write it down? Because I'm going to forget to write it down.
Have you ever... Sorry, go ahead.
I need an alarm. Yeah, no, I'm trying to just do the bit over again because I like to repeat things.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, because just in case you guys didn't get it the first twice.
I'm sitting
times
in
times that I said it two
fucking,
times.
Fucking, oh my God, I'm all over the place.
No way. Me too.
Dude, like, that's, I think we got a lot
yeah,
in common,
like
pal.
How,
I think,
It's funny that you're having trouble staying, like,
focused.
Focused. how jumpy the two of us are. It's like
we're both like two fucking squirrels.
Yeah, I'm going. I just finished like eight different thoughts while you were trying to. You know.
I know. I was
out,
like, I'm talking over
out,
him. Stop talking.
Get out three. It's like, you know. Listen, we're gonna get through it together.
And then I was like, did I miss a bit? And I'm like, I'm ruining this whole show.
No, we're. This is such. This is the exact theme of this whole show.
Oh, I love that.
So when the guest is just as crazy and fucking. Like wild and interruptive and
sick,
loses their train of thoughts as me. It's like, nice, dude. Then I don't look like a complete lunatic. It's
yeah,
like,
that's
dude,
how
I'm
I feel with you
one.
Here. I'm like, he's forgetting I'm here too.
Yes,
he doesn't know where his keys are right now either.
Exactly, dude.
Ready? So, last thing on the tile.
Wait, it's got a wallet.
It's got a wallet. Thing, it's card and it's got a button on it, and sometimes I sit on it weird and my butt starts singing. And when I lose my debit card, everything's happening now. Where it's a fucking tile orgy in this bitch. If I,
that's pretty cool.
So I lose my debit card like quite a bit because I'll take it out in my car to get a coffee or something, and then instead of putting it back in my wallet when I'm driving away because I have to like put them in between my legs because I didn't clean the coffee cup. You know, out of my car before, so it's a bunch of trash and half an ashtray, so I have nowhere to put it, so I have to put it in between my legs. I just throw my fucking debit card onto the passenger seat, and I'm like, all right, I'll put that in my wallet later.
Yeah.
And then about a week later, I'm like, Amanda, have you seen my debit card? And you know the most...
And it's in, but it's not in the seat because it's like worked its way back.
Yeah, I stop short
like
a lot.
In the back seat, or it's...
It's in between. How many times I've like fisted my passenger seat to like reach in the bowels of it? You're like, there's springs in here. I don't understand.
Well, that's how you have to do it. Like, you are really fisting someone because you have to get and then you go into the.
I lube up anyway, just before I can get in there without it.
I'll get it.
But no, a lot of the times I find my shit like by accident. And I'm like, of course that's where it is.
Stumble across
it. Yeah, I'm like,
After you've given up,
yeah,
you're like, well, whatever, dude. It's a lost cause. It'll turn up. And then you stumble across it, and you're like, oh, my God.
Yeah, it'll be like me like outside smoking a joint or something, and I'll be like, I'm going to put my phone right up on top of here, and I never do that in my life. And then it's an hour and a half looking for my phone.
Or you have that one genius moment where you're like, think outside the box. Asshole.
Yeah, you're like, what right? would Jaime
like,
do?
And then you go there, and it's there.
Dude, you feel like
there's no way my fucking keys would be under this thing, behind the thing. But you're thinking like, wait, because I sat down weird.
Yeah, and you go, and I fell asleep.
I fell asleep when I was wearing my pants when I fell asleep watching TV.
Dude, yes.
So maybe, and then you go, and you're like, oh my God. And it's like this giant.
I want to stand up right now.
Like,
from the,
yeah. It's like an adrenaline rush.
That's what I say. I dig myself in holes all day, and I have the best day when I dig myself out of them.
Like, you think you threw a scratch ticket in the trash.
Yes.
And then you find that $100 scratch ticket in the trash.
Exactly.
You're like, it fucking really was in that spot.
Yeah.
Or I dropped my wallet in this parking lot. Maybe I could it.
Yeah.
Did
I'm like,
fucking, did I drop it in the parking lot? You go back and it's lit, sitting
literally
in the
right
spot
where you would have dropped. Yes.
And you're like, oh my fucking God, I'm a retard. And in the same breath, you go, I'm such a retard genius.
I talked to
I'm
my
a
girl.
Genius idiot.
Yeah, you're like, oh my God, I'm like,
such
did
an
I
idiot,
tell the
I'm
future?
Like
am I magic somehow? But I also caused this somehow.
Yeah,
I talk to my girlfriend all the time about it. She's like, you have to like figure something out. Or like we have, because she does the same thing. We're running around looking for shit all day.
We need a system.
We need a system. We got tile. We're losing the tile too. But oh fuck, where
was Google? Was like, there's a thing now. You're like, Google, we have this problem.
Oh yeah.
And Google's
oh.
like tile,
tile, tile.
You're like, hun, fucking, did you know? And she's like, actually, yeah.
We've been talking about these forever. That's another thing on top of it. It's like we just never got them. We were like, we'll get tile.
Because you forgot
one
to get
day.
To the reminder. You forgot to set the alarm.
I didn't write it on my hand or write it on my
phone. To tell you to write on your hand to remind you to go buy a reminder book.
Yeah.
A schedule book to write in.
I got it back, baby. Yeah. What I had a moment ago, I lost it over there. Now I got it back. Fuck. No. No. What is it? Shit.
Wait.
What is it? Shit. That's, what were we talking about? Go backwards. Fuck.
We're the same person. It's hilarious.
I know.
It's hilarious. It's really funny. How old are you?
Mason, is there anyone sitting next to me? Am I having a fucking delusion right now?
Yeah.
Look at
it. I'm May Dan.
He's May Dan.
I'm May Dan.
Actually,
he's Cape Cod Dan.
I'm Cape Cod Dan.
He's 40-year-old Dan because he's 47.
Oh, my God. Imagine if you blinked and you were like, I'm 47.
I look pretty good for 47, though. You got to admit.
Oh, I remember what I was going to say now. Talk to my girlfriend about losing shit all the time. She's always like, you need to come up with some system. And I'm like, why? I always find it. And there's never a punishment in the universe of myself. Because I lose it. And then I'm like, fuck, I really have to get my life together. And then I'll find it. And I'm like, I'll go about my day. as you were. And like, that's it. I'm like, well, okay. And then the next time I lose them, I'm like, you piece of shit. You got to, oh, they're right here. Back to normal. Do you do that? There's no consequence.
No,
because I'm
isn't.
Lucky.
I'm fucking insane. Obviously, I know because we're the same person. So you know.
Unreal.
I don't have to tell you that it's crazy up here. But
dude, I want to be Quincy Thatcher. When, fuck Cape Cod Dan. Yeah. I like Thatcher. That's a cooler name.
But, I was so disorganized, like never cleaned my room. Like I was that kid, like, you know what I mean? Like
can
no
I ask
structure.
You did you ever have a pencil when you were in school? Like in any class, were you that kid?
Oh yeah. We're asking for pencil often.
Yeah. Like you never had one.
Well,
that was a huge thing for me.
Yeah. So
sorry.
No, that's
I'm like, hey, let's go back.
That's like, what's it called? A metaphor. That's like a little metaphor for like the bigger picture. What I'm
talking
about.
Yeah, it's like a fucking sample of
so
my whole life.
But I finally been like, fuck that. I'm going to get organized. I can be in control of my own shit. I'm an adult, so I can put things in their place. You know?
Yeah,
so like
yeah,
You have a place for things.
Dude, this is like my biggest issue in life.
And then when you accidentally don't put that thing in its place,
yeah,
you'll lose your mind. Even more simpler, my tool belt.
Yeah.
If I have my knife, yeah, like in here, for whatever reason, I like put it in here.
Yeah.
I'll go to like grab it and it's like.
Yeah, I know exactly what you're saying.
Like, and I just don't spot it because I'm looking so quick because it's not supposed to be there and I'm losing my shit. I'm like, where's my fucking knife?
Yeah.
Sam, I swear to God, I just had it here.
It's in the
2 seconds
pocket.
Ago. I fucking just had it. And all of a sudden, I'm like, 10 minutes later. I'm like, oh, it's because
right
it wasn't here. It was here.
It was right here. Yeah, it's on the
and
fucking
utility
belt. And
that's how I am with my keys and all that shit. The minute it goes into a spot where it's not normally supposed to go, that's how I fucking lost them in hockey. Because I either like, I locked myself out of my truck, which leads me to believe they came into the rink with me.
Yeah.
But they weren't at the rink. They weren't in the parking lot when I went back there the next day. Dude, it's an anomaly. They're like gone. Or they somehow found their way somewhere in my truck that I still haven't found.
Yeah.
And I just like pulled my keys out of the thing and locked it. But then with the door open, still had to like grab my water and whatever. But I had already locked it. And maybe they were in the center
console.
Yeah,
you do the math.
That's what I'm
like,
thinking I did.
You're like, I did lock it though. So they have to be.
That's
sense.
What I was thinking.
It's like a cold case.
I smoke weed right before I go in. I like of to like course. Get a little high. And so I'm thinking I did the pullout, locked it, but then I went to go grab a water, so that must have been in the center console. I locked them in there.
Yeah.
Then I looked in the truck. They weren't in there. So I'm like, they were not in the truck, but I couldn't find them.
Oh, my God.
So that's –
are you a backpack guy? Like you go out in public, you need like a backpack of things?
No, because I don't live in the city. Like, that's not
right,
that type of area. But when I lived in New York, abso-fucking-lutely.
Yeah, I guess that's more what it is.
The 8 months I lived in New York, I still own the backpack I bought in 2010 or 2009. I love the thing.
I've been,
So, yes.
Do you? Oh, wow. Okay, so you haven't lost the backpack.
What?
You haven't lost the backpack.
Nope.
Wow. Well.
I've kept it all these years. The best backpack I've ever
Sir,
had.
You may have my sword. I always try to be a, that's what I'm trying to get at is I always try to be a backpack guy.
Yeah.
Literally, I'm like, I did it a month and a half ago. I was like, I'm going to buy a fucking agenda. I'm going to have dates of things I'm doing, even if it's just taking a shit. It's going to be in the book.
I have a whiteboard and I don't write anything in it.
I keep thinking I should get a whiteboard.
Yeah, but you're not going to put it.
I know I'm not.
It's going to sit there with the fucking markers and nothing's going to go. The only three things I've written down are the three Saturdays. Dan Hall, I had Brianna last week and I'm having Andrew next week. Those are the only things in my date book. So it's like I feel like, all right, at least I got something.
I have a list that says get a whiteboard so that I can write I got a whiteboard on the whiteboard. Like it's just finishing the
That's
goal.
What I was just talking about. You get the note, the reminder to get the thing that's going to remind you about things.
Goddamn that.
We're fucking ridiculous.
We're going to meld into one person.
We are ridiculous. What's the name of our podcast going to be?
Fucking Lost in the Woods.
It's going to be called What Were We Talking About?
What Were We Talking About?
What Were We Talking About, dude?
What were
it was the fucking, it was the genesis of it started here on January 23rd, 24th, 2021. All right.
What would that break it down to?
The key segment, we're going to end up going 3 hours if we try to get through that keychain.
I only have 14 more.
We're going to do the new segment.
This one's a bottle opener.
I'm excited for this. This will be 2 weeks in a row we've done this segment. We do Fuck, Marry, Kill.
Ooh.
And
I've never had sex.
So here's what I was thinking. I want to get a sound drop that's like either a buzzer or like some type of like sound indicator.
Mm-hmm.
And so that producer Andy can randomly at any point during the podcast hit the sound drop and I'll hear it through the TV because we'll have the TV loud enough.
Yes.
And it'll just be like, bam, 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 or it'll be like,
we were thinking of the same exact
something like that.
Yeah.
And then I'll be like, oh shit, it's time.
You should use then, one of those that you just did.
Okay.
Of you being like, meh, meh. That's perfect.
Like the human car alarm, like, woo,
yeah,
woo,
yeah,
woo,
yeah.
Woo.
Or just be like, dee-doo, you're done.
Dee-doo, dee-doo.
Yeah. That's perfect.
Yeah. All right. So, but then after the sound drop goes, And then we're like, oh shit, it's time.
Yeah.
And I'll be like, it's that time again. And then he'll hit the sound drop again. And it'll be like something along the lines of,
yeah.
Like,
and be like,
Mary, fuck you.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah. I like that we're creating the drop.
Ooh, like a, yeah.
In real time. Yeah. Like, just pretend theater of the mind. Ready?
Fuck Mary. Kill, kill, kill. Kill, kill, kill.
Kill, kill.
Sunday, 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 Sunday. Exactly. All right, so. But I don't know. Here's the thing. Here's the fun of it. So this is why I was asking if you could pull up multiple images. So I would type in the three. I would type in one, comma, the next one, comma, the next one. And that.
He's going to see it.
Yeah, which is fine. That'll be the big reveal. I can reveal. Blindfold you can myself. Say them now.
Guys, I brought my own blindfold.
So we're doing a fuck, marry, kill, but I don't know what they are. So okay. Every week, my producer, Andy, or my guest producer, Mason yeah. Smith. I texted him this before you came. I was like, think of a fuck, marry, kill. Because I can't know it either.
Did you say this was the news segment?
New.
Okay, segment. I was sitting here
you
like,
thought we were going to do the news.
Like, all right, Biden just became president.
Yeah, everybody
think?
Does that shit. No. I want to do different shit. Everybody does.
I'm down for new.
Let's see what's trending on Google and we'll talk about it. No. I don't give a shit about
car check
events.
Out my new podcast.
Yeah, no, I care about smoking weed and getting goofy and being ridiculous.
So why?
Yeah, exactly. So
I don't want to make any points.
I don't want to talk about topical shit. Do we started getting a little political one episode and it got all crazy and then it wasn't about the political shit, but the whole podcast turned into a whole thing.
Dude, I forget
but I don't
what
want
I'm
to
talking
talk
about when we're talking about keys.
Yeah. I don't want
to
talk about
you think
about
I pay attention to exactly. Outside of my own head? Are you the same way?
Yeah, we have already established that we're pretty much the same person from different locations. So yeah, no, I could give a fuck about. Are you the type of person that if you have a thought, you have to share it? You almost
yeah.
have. Like, like there's not a single thing that goes through your head that you can't express to the rest of the world?
Yeah, say what you said again.
Like I don't, like if I think a thing, you have to know what you have to know what I'm thinking all the time.
Right,
like I'm an open book.
You
like
gotta, you gotta. Oh, okay. Yes.
There's no way you don't know what's in my head.
You know what? I want to go with yes.
Yeah.
And I almost have to tell you.
Yeah.
Like I can't not say the thing that I thought.
I'm a little guarded sometimes. I get a little introverted sometimes, but when I'm going
around people you know, though.
Yes.
And if you're around people you don't know,
yeah,
it just takes you a couple of beers, and then the minute
yeah.
you start getting comfortable with everybody,
yep.
it's fucking all 100%. Systems go.
Yeah.
Yep. All right. We're
the
same person.
Exact. And I'm exactly. like, yeah, I'm like, I'm like, my father had cancer this year, but he's fine now. He got clean last week. He went to the doctor. I drove him. And I'm like, why am yeah. I telling you guys this?
Yeah. That's, I used to get my balls busted so much growing up, but then I used to be like, dude, it's so easy for you guys to bust my balls because I literally share everything about my life. So
yeah.
like when you know me inside and out and like every insecurity I have and it's pretty easy to fucking make fun of me.
Yeah.
I actually got to do work and like try and
right.
be creative.
Right.
Okay?
I got to go off appearance
yeah.
first.
Yeah. I actually have to be fucking witty. You guys fucking got all the ammo in the world.
Yeah. I mean, that's a lot of comics thing, I think, but it's like, I get to it first, basically. I'm getting there before you are. I know what...
Self-deprecating.
I know what everyone's going to say.
Yeah.
You know, whatever. Going backwards. Hold on now. Yeah, saying shit too much. Yeah, it's like you start saying... I always say I have little brother syndrome, where it's like when I get a chance to talk, it's like, get it all out. It's not organized, but just get it out
I'm
of his
head.
I'm
the older brother with little brother syndrome
yeah,
somehow.
Yeah, yeah.
And my brother's the one who's just stoic, reserved, like whatever. It,
right,
that's
yeah.
funny. He's, but that's funny. That's hilarious.
Yeah, we're the idea men of the family.
Yeah, we're the visionaries.
We're the Edisons of our family.
Yeah, exactly.
Watch out, light bulb.
Yeah, okay. All right, we got to do this because what time is it? All right, I still got time. I was like, oh, shit. If you said 6:30, I would have been like, oh, shit. I have hockey at 7:30.
As soon as it's dark, it's like, fuck.
I know. Well, 8:30 feels like 10:30 now.
Yeah.
Almost 11 o'clock because this whole curfew bullshit, it's like everything shuts down at 9 o'clock, 9:30, 10 o'clock. So,
yeah.
9 o'clock feels fucking late because the bars close in a half an hour. So it's like that weird perspective thing.
Yeah, it's like, exactly. It's like, I also, during daylight savings, I think fucking just traffic.
So daylight
savings, everyone's trying to beat the night.
Arizona home. Got it all figured out. They're like, what's the fucking, why?
Did they not do it?
I think it's Arizona. There's one, is it, I think Arizona doesn't do daylight savings. Just type in what state doesn't do
daylight. I got it. Yeah. Oh, you were reading my mind.
All right. Some people don't know. Some people have a struggle with keywords. Start, it's like very simple to Google a thing if you just write in exactly what you want to know.
Mason goes, I got it. America, 50 states. All right.
And then we got to do the fuck, Mary,
Breaking
kill.
Bad.
Listen, I'll do 3 hours. I'll do 5 hours. I could give a fuck. But personally, I don't think people.
That's Thatcher. That's Arizona.
Watch.
Doesn't do daylight savings.
You're right. Okay, I got. You're
like
right.
I said, Arizona doesn't
right.
do daylight.
Right.
That was
like
your
said,
thought,
right,
dude.
Said,
we're
right,
starting
right.
to mend. It's crazy.
Sorry. All right, so give us the scenario. Fuck, marry, kill.
Yeah. Okay. So fuck, marry, kill. Donald Trump. Oh wait. Fuck. Here we go.
Who?
Fuck, marry, kill. Donald Trump. Betty White. Now. And Roseanne.
Betty White now. Roseanne now.
Oh, yeah, all now.
I'm going to kill Betty White right off the jump.
Oh, I gotta write
that. Am I not supposed to? Wait, am I not supposed to do it?
No, you.
I was like, did I just say
no.
it wrong? I'm like,
and
are
I
you
decided,
related to Betty,
so
Betty White?
This will also be one of the clips, too. So we'll do, when I do the promo Betty clips,
White. Yeah,
I'm going to do. Everyone's answer, but not their explanation. So it'll just be a quick little clip of everyone's answer. A little teasy, but not their explanation. So,
Jimmy Leg.
Wow, you're going to kill Betty White off the bat.
Yeah.
I honestly, I'm very interested for this one because now. All right.
Okay, here's the thing.
Yeah.
It's like a bit at this point that Betty White is still alive.
Yeah.
Right? It's like memes and shit. It's like, you know, breaking news. Betty White is fine. That's like a bunch. I see that all the time. I follow a lot of Betty White pages. I'm a fan. I'm a super fan. Call the girls, baby.
I'm so glad I didn't just spit my beer out.
I would have loved to spit
take.
Would
have ruined my awesome champion sweatshirt.
Because of all that hype of her being alive, you want to be the one to kill her. I mean, I don't want to kill anybody, but all if right. I'm a murderer, you know, that guy went away for John Lennon to be like, I just wanted to be the guy who killed John Lennon. And he is. And I'd be like the guy who killed Betty White. But I hope I get to fuck someone before I go to jail.
I almost kind of see where you're going with this.
You know what I mean? It's like about cloud of killing Betty White. And she's the closest to the end. Oh, wait. Who's the other one? Donald Trump?
Yeah, right. So either you didn't think this through, or I kind of see where you're going with this. Because can I finish your scenario? Because because I feel like you forgot that Donald Trump was part of the scenario. You're
no,
like,
I got
second.
One for him.
Okay, all right.
But all if right, you then. Wait, I want you to like, I'll believe you. Just like think about what the scenario I'm gonna say is, just to see if we both got it.
Okay.
I'm going to fuck Donald Trump.
All right. No. Okay. Different. We're different then.
See? Exactly the same. I'm going to fuck Donald Trump because it's so masculine to fuck a guy. Thank you.
Yeah. And plus the country. Like you would essentially be, well, for 50% of the country. You would essentially alienate half the country and be beloved by another half of the country.
Yeah. And I get to jizz. In the DJT's tight ass.
By the way, I think I've decided that the podcast at the beginning is going to get a parental advisory logo, like the old school, like
oh, that's
CD
sick.
Parental
yeah, yeah.
advisory logos too. Because for sure, we go ham.
Wait, who's it? Oh, Roseanne. Yeah, she gets fucking wild.
Yeah.
We're gonna have some fist fights.
You can share her Ambien.
Yeah, we're
gonna
snort Ambien together.
Tweets.
I'm going to snort Ambien off
her
tits.
So, all right, in your scenario.
I'm going to ghost run her account.
I totally now get why you, like, killing Betty White. Like,
it's all for
like,
clout.
Yeah.
It's for the check mark.
Fuck your meme. Like, you're a contrarian.
I'll come back like OJ and be like, hello, Twitter.
Betty White's alive, really?
Yeah, right. I'm the one that took care of it for us, guys.
Yeah.
You know?
But then from there, where I would move to is I would fuck Roseanne.
Oh, yeah. Why didn't I do it that way?
And I would just marry Donald Trump because you never fuck who you're married to.
You're never
anyway,
gonna see
right?
it. You're so right, dude. But then you don't
classic,
get to fuck him in the
classic
ass.
Joke. Classic joke. Right? I mean, it was right there. Low hanging fruit. But my scenario.
Yeah, give me yours.
Well, again, shit. I mean, after now that I've explained, now that I've was talking about your scenario, I've realized that by doing what I'm going to do, mm-hmm. I'm also going to alienate half the country.
Sure.
Pretty much no matter what you do with Donald Trump.
Because it's gay marriage?
No. No matter what you do with Donald Trump.
It's bad.
You're going to alienate yourself from half the country. So yeah. it's a lose-lose.
Yeah.
Even having him in this scenario.
Isn't that just what government is, man? It's
yeah,
a big game of fuck,
a
marry, kill.
Man, just bringing us down, dude.
You got fuck, marry,
yeah,
bills.
We can't even do a fuck, marry, kill, man, yeah. Without the fucking man bringing us down.
Demonetized already.
All right. I would kill Donald Trump.
Hero.
Because I, yeah.
Just kid.
Yeah. Obvious, right?
Whatever.
Pander.
See you later.
We're not all above pandering, okay? Kill Donald Trump.
Give it up for the troops, and I kill Donald Trump.
Yeah. I would fuck Betty White, because like you said, she doesn't have much. She doesn't have that much.
She doesn't
much.
Have a lot left.
And,
She had a wild thought. When do you think the last time Betty White boned?
Listen, there's supplements. There's sexual supplements. There's things that help. Listen, I'm not saying it's appealing. No, this is not really an appealing scenario.
She doesn't smell like powder?
Dude, we've got a Sophie's choice here, but we just added one child to the mix. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah,
it's not really...
Yeah.
None of these scenarios are desirable. So I'm going in for Betty White because whatever, you know? Mm-hmm. She could use a young stud before she
sure,
goes out.
Sure, yeah,
like,
just one more.
The lady's a national treasure. Let her go out with some happiness.
Yeah, golden child.
You know what I mean? I'll be her
girl.
Anna Nicole Smith.
I thought you just said I'll beat Anna Nicole Smith, and I was like, someone right. did.
Like I said, I'll kill Donald Trump, pandering. At least half the country, I'll be essentially like their god. Their
yeah,
king.
Yeah.
Right?
You're in on one side, at least.
At least one side.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'll lose a bunch of friends.
Yeah.
It's fine. And then you marry Roseanne. Because, like, I mean, her fucking...
She got syndication money, baby.
Syndication money. She's fucking loaded.
She's on Cozy TV.
Right? But in the event that you get divorced...
Yeah. You don't sign a prenup.
You're going to fucking...
Oh, yeah, because that's what Tom Arnold did, right?
Tom Arnold, baby.
Tom Arnold, fucked her for all her money,
he
right?
He got one for the good... He didn't fuck her for her money. They got divorced, and he happened to be one of the few guys that... Got the
wow.
good end of this.
Tom
deal.
Arnold's a personal hero.
That's yeah. sick.
Yeah.
I always mixed up him and Dennis Quaid.
One of my good friends got divorced from a lady with money, and he moved, like, he basically uprooted his whole life, like, moved to Pennsylvania. Then he moved to New Hampshire. They had a house together. He was building a deck, like investing money into the place.
Building a deck
and
is an investment.
They got divorced, and he essentially just, like, went on his way. And I was like, dude, you... You could have gotten half. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
There's actually a dude who advertises on the radio. I don't know if he does anymore. Irwin Pollock. Have you ever heard of Irwin Pollock?
I have not.
He basically is one of those guys fighting for the guys in the world, around the world, and getting them half.
Hey, do you rock?
Are you? Call Irwin Pollock. And I used to joke with him, like, dude, why didn't you call Irwin Pollock? What the fuck's wrong with you?
It's like Morgan and Morgan. They're like, I don't know where I was going with. They're lawyers as well. That's
yeah.
all I had there.
Yeah. They're all scumbags. Well, defense lawyers. Give it up for defense lawyers.
Yeah.
Prosecutors, go fuck yourself. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, for sure.
Oh, you got bullied. Fucking, we get it. You know what I mean? Stand up for the fucking what's right. I had to go to court 3 times over some bullshit. Just like my mirror got.
That's what I was
Mason knows the whole story, but it's a long story short. But just getting to sit there and seeing the difference between like a defense lawyer and a prosecutor. It's like such a different breed of human.
Yeah, yeah.
So there's a nerd versus like that fucking whatever, like the cool kid, right, the frat kid, right. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
who's sit just down, like, pussy.
Yeah, dude, it's hilarious.
Prosecutor's like, oh,
but
man.
Mason, I don't know if you know this, but the producer also has to contribute to the fuck, marry, kill. So you're gonna have to give us your scenario.
I would kill Donald Trump. Fuck Betty White and marry Roseanne.
See, I think you guys are missing how masculine it is to tear up a man's asshole.
No, you're right. You're right. No, it's not a gay thing. It's just purely male.
No,
it's about
no,
male
it
dominance.
No, not that. It's because I just hate Donald Trump.
It's about male. It's about male dominance. So.
You can hate someone and still find them attractive.
Yeah,
that's true.
I wanted to hate fuck my old landlord's wife. Yeah,
you probably get
essentially,
away with it now.
It's more roommates. You call it roommates, but like
he owned
the place.
Oh, okay, yeah, that is a different dynamic. I had like a way.
But, she was such a bitch, but
she was
also attractive. You know, it's one of those like. And there was one night we were playing poker, and I was a little buzzed, and she was looking really good, and I was just like, man, I could totally hate fuck the
shit
out of this girl. She was a Skylar, but I never really wanted to fuck Skylar. Like, I was never that attracted to Walt's wife.
Me neither.
All right. We're going to wrap it up, I think.
Okay, yeah. I feel like we could go forever.
Like, we could literally go forever.
We keep going.
Yeah.
You know when you used to plug Game Boys in to battle Pokemon with a USB cord? That's where we're at right now.
Yeah, that's
baby.
Where we're at. We're like, dude, another game. We're like me and my buddy. Dude, my buddy got Madden once. And I went on a fucking tear and beat him like 20 games. Like, it was so embarrassing how many games in a row. And it's like, you know, run it back. Like, you lose. You're like, run it back.
Yeah, yeah.
We're like 25 years old, by the way, at this
point.
Yeah.
Man's
we're
the
adults.
Only game.
We're adults, right? It's fucking 2 in the morning. His girl got home from work at like 10 a.m., went to bed. Or not 10 at night, right? Went to bed. It's still 3 in the morning. Like, we're sitting there on the couch while she's asleep. Playing video, he's like, run it back,
yeah.
Run it back. Like,
it's like, honestly, it's like editing or doing like a pod where video games are, you know,
when you have an addictive personality, right?
Yeah, like, you just get into it and you're like, oh, we've been doing this for 3 hours now.
Yeah, I am a very, while I am a hermit, I'm very sociable in the sense that the minute I start like hanging out with people,
yeah,
I don't want it to end. I could do it
forever.
Like, it could just go.
Yeah.
We could do this for 6 hours.
Yeah.
When I watch a podcast, a 3-hour podcast, which there's not that many of them.
Right.
Joe
you're
Rogan
upset when
is,
it's
the,
over.
Is the quintessential example.
Yeah, right, right.
But like if he had like a Neil deGrasse Tyson on or Elon Musk, it's like, dude, 6-7 hours. I don't give a fuck, dude.
Yeah.
I'm enjoying this. Keep it going.
I used to drive for a living, and now I do nothing for a living, so I got a lot of time on my hands.
Plenty of time, right? So,
yeah, I'm totally.
This
dead.
Has been a blast.
Yeah, hell yeah.
We end with a segment. Mason, can you pass that pad and paper? It's much better if we write it down.
Yeah.
So you're gonna write down one word or phrase. Any one word or phrase. And I have to say it with a smile into the camera.
Oh, okay, so it's got to be silly.
What it can be serious.
Okay.
I mean, you can whatever you might. Do you have a charity? You have a charity that you want to promote? Like it doesn't have to be silly. It could be serious. It could be silly. It could be racist. But the people,
because you say it,
the people viewing are gonna know that you wrote it.
No, I'm
so
like
no
Jeff
matter
Dunham,
yeah.
I'm throwing it over to you, baby.
Yeah,
all right.
Dan's gonna hack my computer and then edit it so it just looks like I just said it, and they're not gonna see this moment where you
oh,
wrote
this
it
part.
Down. Yeah, no, I'm joking.
Oh,
this
really?
Is a joke.
I'm like, I know so many words and I can't think of any.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be. It could be a phrase too, one word or phrase.
Oh, man.
It's this. By the way, this is slightly a ripoff on Andrew Santino's podcast. He has the guests say one word or phrase into the camera. But I'm doing a similar thing where you make me say.
I got it.
See? All right.
I got it, everybody.
Oh, and hey, before we do this, though, before I wrap it up, do you have anything you want to plug?
Just follow me at Puke Night Dan on Instagram. And if you're on TikTok, Danny Hall, spelled like Annie Hall, but with a D. Thank you.
So are all your all the videos that I see on Facebook, they're on Instagram as well?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Puke Night Dan on Instagram.
Puke Night Dan.
His videos are hilarious. My personal favorites are the Shark Tank one and more recently the Kanye's lawyer one.
Hold on, I got it.
All right.
Wait, I'm so sorry. Thank you.
Don't apologize. This was a blast. This
Hold
was
on.
Awesome.
Wait.
Mason, thank you for guest producing today. You guys are like, who's the bearded guy that I feel like I recognize him from before? Mason Smith was guest on episode 4, and because we switched to Sunday, we normally do this on Saturday, but we had to switch to Sunday. Because Dan had to watch his sister's kids.
My niece, baby.
And my buddy Andy, producer Andy, had to go do something. So thank you, Mason, for coming down to guest produce for us tonight.
Absolutely. It was very fun.
I enjoyed listening.
Can I plug my podcast?
You can absolutely plug your podcast. It's going to get plugged next week also when Andrew's here.
Andrew's coming on?
Yeah.
Like and subscribe to High Noon wherever you get your podcast. Follow us on Instagram at @HighNoon_pod.
@HighNoon_pod wherever you get your pods, guys.
You can follow me on Instagram at Mason E. Smith.
Yeah, follow him at Mason E. Smith. And I'm going to have Mason and his wife carry on probably in a couple weeks. I'm going on vacation a week after next when Andrew's on, but I feel like the week after that you guys should come, or like in the next couple of weeks from that we're going to have you guys down.
Also, we got Welcome to the Smiths going back on now.
Oh,
so
really?
We're going to have you on that soon. And you
nice. That's you and
that's
your wife?
Me and Carrie. It's our podcast.
That's awesome.
We're going to try to get that going once a week now, too.
Hell yeah. Are you just starting that? Or you did it?
We started it back at the beginning of quarantine.
So you have one or two
just
episodes?
Like haven't, and then we had two guests, and one is we just released. It was Nat, buddy Nat Rogachevsky.
You always have guests?
Yeah.
So it's always
the
you two?
The first one is just Carrie and I. Talk just like it's like a 45-minute episode of just her and I, and right. Then the second episode we have a guest.
All right, nice, awesome. You guys heard it right there.
Yeah, baby. I have an action in my.
All
in
right,
my script.
It's I have a whole script I have to act out. Oh shit! This is the first time I've gotten a script.
I'll send you over a quick draft. I couldn't think of anything,
dude. No, this is perfect. Because I was just about to say, when are we starting? When are we starting our podcast called What Are We? What were we
what
talking
were we just
about?
Talking about?
Fuck yeah! Wait. What were we just talking about, dude? I tricked everybody.
I didn't know what was
happening. You didn't know
I
was doing the thing, but that's what he wrote down.
You gotta yell it. You gotta go. Wait, what were we talking about, dude?
All right, wait. Can I do that? Can I do that again?
Do it. Take two.
That's anybody who's seen enough of my sets knows that's one of my little bits where I go, I start fucking up a joke and I go, I'll look at a crowd member and I'll go, wait. I go, hold on. Can I start that over? Can
oh,
I
my that God. Again? That's
it,
great.
It gets a chuckle.
No,
every
yeah, that's the difference between a live is there's no crowd.
Yeah, dude, it's fucking bullshit.
Can't riff on anybody if it's going
All right,
on.
I got to yell this, so I'm going to put this way. How loud? Like,
just like,
give me direction.
Just like we were talking about, like the best thing ever, and you're like, what? You don't have to say fuck, but like, you're like, what?
How would I do it?
What's his motivation?
Yeah, do it like you, I guess.
How would I do it? What's my motivation?
Yeah, if you do it a cool way, I get it.
Wait. What the fuck were we just talking about, dude?
That was it. I like that. Yeah, the fuck? There's a little improv in there?
That feel like organic? Good. All right. We did it.
We did it?
We did it.
Do I like
we're
it?
And cut.
Quality content.
Hey.